Hey everybody, welcome to WDW News Tonight. Tonight, the start of the show is going to be a little different. You probably heard by now that we lost a member of the WDWNT family.
We're having a problem. Oh, the TV's on. Great. We're doing great. The TV's echoing into here, just so you guys are aware. Great.
Josh is laughing somewhere right now. It's fine. So we lost a member of the WDWNT family a couple days ago, our good friend Josh from EasyWDW.com. So we want to take a couple minutes here at the top of the show to talk about Josh. Of course, Josh has been on this show 100 times, and it's funny that this is March Madness starting tonight, because that was a thing Josh was a big part of. But Josh was a big part of not just our shows, it was a big part of our lives. Myself in particular, Josh and I... Do you want to fix that TV now?
Is it this TV?
Yeah, the only TV on the set. Yeah. We're doing great. live show.
Josh,
fun of a live show.
Right,
Josh would be heckling me right now. Yeah, he's like, good job. You've only been doing this for 6 years.
It's not like you guys rehearsed this before.
Yeah, yeah. So obviously, we lost Josh this week, and Josh was a big part of not only, you know, our on-air life, but personal life. Josh and I became really close after I, you know, I was engaged at one point and then wasn't. And I remember my mother asking, are you gonna go home now? Like, is there anything for you here? And I think a big reason why I stayed was Josh. I actually had friends here and friends that shared interests and we could go do things. And I was like, things seem like they're gonna be all right. I think I'm gonna stay here in Florida. So I mean, honestly, if it wasn't for Josh, I don't know that we'd be in this room right now. I don't know that this studio would be here. I don't know that I'd be here. So personally and professionally, I owe a lot of everything to Josh. So it's funny, we brought up the heckling thing. A fun Josh story is, you may remember, I don't remember what episode it was, but a couple months ago, we were doing the monologue, and Nick, playfully, Josh started to heckle Nick.
The whole show.
On the air.
Was it
the whole show?
Well, I was also pitching, I think, attraction ideas or something like that.
Oh, okay.
I think it was something I was pitching and drawing on. Yeah. And, yeah, I mean, this, he was heckling me from the audience. I mean, I knew it was out of, you know, just being funny, just being Josh, but, you know, very, you know, it's just very touching. Like a couple of weeks later, he showed up with a bunch of presents for me. Like he felt bad about it. He got me this like Star Wars role-playing board game and this like Darksaber lamp because he knew I like Star Wars.
I feel like you're underselling it. Like he bought you.
He did. It was a lot of
several hundred dollars in
gifts
because he fake heckled you on the show and felt bad.
It was very expensive and a lot of stuff. And I mean, it was. It was weird because, like, I always saw Josh as this guy who just, like, you know, made jokes about things, and I took it for what it was. I mean, it's not like I ever took offense to any of that. That was Josh, and but giving me those gifts, that was also Josh. I mean, he was this really sweet guy who was really great to talk to. You know, like. And I mean, I wish I got as close to him as you did. I mean, I never did. Yeah.
But no, those brief moments at every restaurant review.
Oh.
Yeah.
I mean, every time hanging out with him was memorable. It really was.
My favorite was always when we had new staff members and I would invite them to those new restaurant reviews. And I'd be like, how are people going to react to Josh? Because no one ever knew if he was joking or not at first.
You have no idea.
And then once you're in on it, once you understood that he was joking with you, then it was amazing. But
that was the appeal. I loved reading his reviews because it was just, even in his writing, there was that sarcasm I had no idea if it was real or not, but I didn't care because it was entertaining. And that was,
if you want to honor Josh, there's one thing I recommend you read. There's a review of a pizza burger. It was at Cosmic Rays Starlight Cafe. I don't think the thing lasted very long because it was awful. But the review, I've read it like 6 times before, is my favorite thing. It is really, if you're not familiar with Josh's stuff, go to EZWW, check it out. But Josh as a person beyond, I don't have to tell you how funny he was. Like, it's kind of sacrilegious that this group of people has a comedy show because Josh was funnier than all of us put together. But
the 10th dragon,
yeah, Josh the 10th dragon, yeah. But Josh was the most caring, the absolute most selfless person I've ever met. Like, literally only cared about other people. Like, that was the one thing I could say. And I don't say that just because he's gone.
Yeah.
Like, even before that, I would tell people, yeah, like, absolutely selfless person. All Josh ever wanted was out of the site. Wasn't money or fame. It was really, he got such joy out of people telling him that he made their trips better. Like, that's what Josh was out there for. I mean, we talk about consumer advocacy. I don't think there's ever been anyone, as far as the Disney parks are concerned, that's ever done for consumers what Josh did. I think he really helped thousands and thousands and thousands of people have a better trip. And I will say this, like, it doesn't matter what algorithm, you know, app, whatever was out there, no one did a better touring plan than Josh. There was no one with any degree or books or whatever that touched Josh in that department. No one could ever dream to. So, So obviously, we're going to be paying tribute to Josh in a lot of ways in the coming weeks. We are going to be doing a charity benefit show in his honor. There will be details down the road, obviously. We'll get back to you in the next couple of days with that information. But for the time being, we obviously wanted to honor him on a show. He was such a big part of. Josh was always willing to give up his whole Thursday night to come do this show. And not just Thursday night. I know, going back to the radio show, Josh would take that hour and a half drive with me out to Apopka.
Yeah.
And sit there, and we'd go through all the Flower and Garden or Food and Wine Festival reviews. And Josh was a great friend, a great part of the show, and we'll miss him. And Josh, wherever you are, I love you deeply, and I'm going to miss you a lot. And I think I speak, obviously, if you saw what everyone said on Twitter and Facebook and beyond, like, a lot of people are going to miss Josh. So thank you, Josh. We love you, and we remember you.
Oh, yeah.
This is the best 200 core bucks I've ever
had. Oh, yeah.
But you get kicked off of 4 podcasts, and what do?
Go to Tom Corless.
Some of them may go shorter. Some of them, you know, like Lilliputian Land, I think everyone's expecting that to be a quick discussion. What have I got myself in?
Good luck.
live from WDWNT Celebration near the Walt Disney World Resort. It's WDW News Tonight with Tom Corless and Nick LoCicero. Tonight, March Madness 2022 begins with the 64 greatest attraction scenes in Walt Disney World history, a special St. Patrick's Day edition of Liquid Magic, and more. I'm Nick LoCicero. Now, here's your host, Tom Corless.
Hello, I'm Tom Corless, and if you thought episode 200 was long, you're in for a surprise. Ready. Probably not the level of surprise of Bob Chapek seeing himself get decimated on John Oliver on HBO, but somewhere in that zone. How about that? Remember, Bob, when a talk show with 20,000 viewers was your biggest problem? You remember that? Those are the good old days for Mr. Chapek,
yeah. Right?
The good old What is this?
It's an old rocket, but I do.
What?
Tom, this is Merida from Brave.
Hiya.
Why?
All right.
Why?
It's St. Patrick's Day, of course. Come on.
I don't know, Kel. Right.
What?
Tom, she said Happy St. Patrick's Day.
She's Scottish.
It's today. It happens all the time. It's a big mess, though. Well, one time I gave my mother a cake, and she turned a big old air. And then my old yin tried to do in. Oh, that wasn't a mess. I don't know what it is.
Please leave.
Oh, don't be a wood kill. Oh, all right, okay. All right.
Bye.
Crowd, great.
We got a meet and greet set up. Yeah.
Distance, though. What is there like a?
Of course.
We'll use Pete's discarded Guinness bottles. We'll make a barrier. Make a barrier. Thanks. Wait, boy.
She said she.
Okay.
Oh yeah, we can't wait for Liquid Magic either. Yeah. Love it.
Please hit the like button. Subscribe. They're like, no one would hit the like button. This is the dumbest show. Why would you? Please hit the like button, subscribe, and if you're really enjoying this nonsense, you can leave a super chat. Your donations will be used to add some sort of theme to the new Polynesian resort villas. We'll go out there. We're going to Pete with a stepladder. We're going to try to hang some, like, I don't know, some Hawaiian stuff up. Like a wood dolphin. Just something.
Sounds good.
We'll have Lucas make a wood dolphin. We'll send Pete down there with it and just put it over the door. We did it. There you go. Oh boy. Now the news.
News.
Hi, news.
Oh my goodness. The news. Let me scroll down. Oh yeah, the Interglobe Society. Thank you, Lauren, good save. Brought to you by the WDWNT Interglobe Society, which is important tonight because our post show has a whole separate March Madness tournament for you. The bathroom tournament starts tonight as well. That'll be in hour five. So stay tuned for that. So have you seen this newly announced Polynesian building? You seen this?
I have.
Yeah, I guess between the Parish drone show and the positive Galactic Star Cruiser reviews, things were going too well. So Chapek was like, we got to alienate half my employees and announce something bad just to get back to normal. I got to get back to normal.
Yeah.
The new DVC wing will feature more villas, recreation, and dining. The new restaurant inside there will be called Ohana's. We have that. There it is. Ohana's will be in there. So. Come on. Come on, everybody.
He's a dumb head and bish.
All right. Some people on Diz Twitter are defending the design, saying not everything has to be heavily themed. They then went on to eat at Tony's and said, not all food needs to taste good. Like, this is, sometimes it's just to eat, you know, to taste.
Then they watched the show and said, not all,
not all comedy shows have to be
funny.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Some people joke that they're adding a Courtyard by Marriott to the Seven Seas Lagoon. But then these people, they came back to them and said they would like to know where these Courtyard by Marriotts are that look just like the Polynesian. They're like, none of these look like, well, let me help you. There's one. There's another. There's another one. I think that's, that's Albuquerque. We have Galveston. There's another one. Yep, there's a lot of them.
I've stayed at a lot of them.
You've stayed at these, Pete?
A lot.
After Lauren kicked you out of the house?
Well, no,
you
start
make a tour of me? People groan. The Guinness bottle joke, they all die. The one that Lauren kicked them out is the one where everyone drew the line.
Slept on a lot of couches.
They're still going, by the way. There's more of there's more of these. They also have Riviera. Courtyard also has a Riviera and that new Disneyland DVC. They've got one of those. They've got the whole DVC portfolio. In fact, the Courtyard by Marriott. Yeah. So Disney was found, oh boy, let's go down this path. Disney was found to have financially supported every sponsor of the Don't Say Gay or Parental Rights in Education bill. In fairness though, they thought it was the Don't Say Pay bill. they were surprised when they found out.
It's a lot to grow. Hey, Jagger.
The bill has been criticized. There's someone crying in the front row. I don't know. The bill, is the show that bad? The bill has been criticized for its vague language regarding discussing issues in classrooms. The vague language all makes sense when you find out it was written by the Disney Parks Board. Where is the building going? Wait, what? Where is it? I don't know. What, is ESPN Club gone? I don't know. They didn't say. It's a cake place now? I don't know. Disney CEO Bob Chapek made a statement and then sent out a company-wide email regarding the bill, neither of which denounced the bill. But then he finally did denounce it after it had already passed the Senate and after he was publicly roasted, more importantly, which is, I enjoyed that. Chapek attempted to then pledge donations to organizations, including the HRC, to save face, but the HRC subsequently turned down the money, saying between this and turning red going straight to Disney Plus, we can't in good conscience. We can't in good conscience take this.
I did.
Yeah, exactly. Chapek said Disney will now reconsider political donations moving forward. Proposal, however, that would have required Disney to report all lobbying efforts did not pass among shareholders, though. But in fairness, neither did the proposal to add a third register to Woody's Lunchbox. That was again turned down.
You just can't get anything done.
No. But the Courtyard by Maui.
Oh, yeah. That,
Courtyard by Maui's going on. In a tweet sent Saturday evening, California Governor Gavin Newsom extended an olive branch towards the Walt Disney Company following antagonizing comments from Florida Governor Ron DeSantis regarding the bill. And Newsom said, quote, Disney, the door is open to bring those jobs back to California, the state that actually represents the values of your workers. Upon going through said door, Disney found themselves in the Himalayas eating yellow snow cones. So it's going well. Face masks, which governor do you want? Neither one's really going to help you. Face masks are now optional for fully vaccinated guests aboard the Disney Skyliner at Walt Disney World. However, you may still want to bring your helmet in case of collisions.
Yeah.
Don't need that. Oh boy. Pecos Bills at the Magic Kingdom has two new items inspired by the Country Bear Jamboree. There's the Sun Bonnet Trio Strawberry Salad and Teddy Barra's Swingin' Shortcake. The shortcake, we all know, is named after all the fist fights recently at the park. The swingin' Shortcake. The salad honors Bunny, Bubbles, and Beulah, which also happen to be the three key ingredients in Tony's chicken parmesan. I think Merida shot the bunny.
I have excitement on my own end.
Yep. A drill team. Oh, good. We have more offensive stories to talk about. Let's go. A drill team known as the Indianettes was not allowed to wear headdresses included in their uniform when performing at the Magic Kingdom. Though they did not wear the headdresses, they did have feathers in their hair, and their fringe uniforms were reminiscent of Native American clothing. And they then performed a dance and song that parodies Native American ceremonies, including chanting "Scalp 'em." Of course, Disney security immediately went after them at this point, thinking they were reselling park tickets. So, that's when they cared. That's the point at which they're like, we gotta step in, boys. Let's go. And, oh, boy. Thanks for the vote of confidence, Pete. I appreciate it.
We're good. Does Merida like it?
All the redheaded people just keep yelling out in the middle of my monologue. You know.
All right, okay.
That was Spanish, I think. Okay. Okay. In all seriousness.
I wasn't asking the question.
It's bad. How much of that drink did I have before the show? She's starting to make sense.
Yeah.
I almost understood that one. I'm worried. I'm concerned now. In all seriousness, Bob Chapek did have some advice for the Indianettes. He suggested they change their name to the Donettes and acquire a sponsorship from Hostess. He's like, that's where the real money is, kids. Sponsorships. After he then drove away in his Alamo rental car. After rumors circled, thanks to Disney Food Blog, as to why the Russian soda flavor at Club Cool, oh good, more controversy.
Oh boy.
As to why that Russian soda flavor was gone, the Sprite Cucumber was unavailable. The flavor then returned to the shop. Yeah, it turns out the Russian soda was unable to get through the case of superior Ukrainian Coke that was in the way. It couldn't get through. Yikes. That was bad. There was a real Sabrina laugh in there, which is when I know it's when I know things are bad. The character didn't laugh. The actor did. It's bad.
Not okay.
Yeah.
The Blue Bayou restaurant at Disneyland will close for an undisclosed period of time starting April 21st. But until then, guests are actually eating up against construction walls inside the restaurant because Pirates is closed. So there's just tables up against construction walls. Yeah. Who said the Epcot experience was closed?
Nah.
It's alive and well. Oh boy. I can't. I can't anymore. When you got nothing left to preview, you might as well close it. Right. The fan favorite Mickey ice cream bars have finally made their way to Disneyland Paris. They're selling for €4.50. They look almost just like the ones here, but they're slightly different. Jake, do we have the Paris Mickey ice cream bar? There they are.
So, Jakey Fish.
Light one of those Mickey bars up and enjoy a drone show.
It melts from the middle.
It melts from the middle. Oh, boy. We don't talk about Bruno from Encanto will be performed live for the first time at this year's Oscars, airing on ABC March 27th, which is usually where they don't talk about Roman Polanski. So, just want to make sure everyone's alienated.
Sure.
At this point. Yeah, it's a good thing. I mean, the Russian audience can't even watch right now, so it's fine.
Yes.
Sure. Shanghai Disney Resort has announced a multi-year contract with McDonald's China to release Disney toys and Happy Meals. The first round of toys inspired by characters and attractions at Shanghai Disney Resort are available now. You can get them with either a Bat Burger or the Pangolin McNugget Happy Meal. So go ahead. Oh. Oh, no.
One more. We're almost there. Almost there.
Disney is considering launching a cheaper version of Disney Plus with ads in the U.S. This isn't a joke, Pete. This is real. They're considering releasing a Disney Plus version with ads in it. It'll be cheaper. The new tier of the streaming service could help Disney reach their goal of making their direct-to-consumer sector profitable by 2024. They also said there's a version of Lightning Lane with ads coming soon as well. So it's a projector that just follows you down the queue. Watch that. Who brings us the news? Oh, you reminded me about another thing. It's not even in there. Hey, did you hear everybody? Did you hear at Avengers Campus, they put a dedication plaque for Stan Lee at the land in California Adventure. There's a dedication plaque for Stan Lee there. The guy's dead. Hasn't he been through enough? He's got to be associated with, oh, come on. See, we should have just left it. We should. There it is. There it is.
Hey, all right, let's burn that in.
Thank you, Lori.
All right, all right.
The saddest thing is that joke was written 3 weeks ago. We forgot to. I forgot to put it in the script, and I should have. It was an omen. It was an omen to not. Who would dare put their name on this segment? Oh, it's us, of course. Go ahead.
This program is brought to you by WIGS, the WDWNT Interglobe Society. Support WDWNT to get early and exclusive access to content you can't find anywhere else, including exclusive post shows for WDW News Tonight and Park Center, exclusive programs including our retro-riffing show, Ride Rehab Watches, bonus episodes of Club 22, and a monthly Zoom with Tom, access to our Discord community, and much more, starting at just $2 a month. For more information, visit patreon.com/WDWNT or visit WDWNT.com and click the Patreon link. Join WIGS and unlock even more WDWNT.
Yes, and a very special thank you to the three remaining WIGS watching at home. Thank you. We have WIGS here tonight. Any WIGS members? Thank you. Thank you for being here. We appreciate it. We have a lot of show tonight. We're already a half hour in and struggling. It's great.
Sure.
So we have, obviously, March Madness starting tonight. The 64 best attraction scenes in the history of Walt Disney World are going to battle it out. In addition to that, a St. Patrick's Day edition of Liquid Magic.
Oh, so dangerous.
We will have an actual Irish character on this show
yeah.
in Pete. So, yes, one real Irish character. That and more coming your way tonight. Stick around.
Now is the time. Now is the best time. Now is the best time of your life. Life is a prize. Live every minute. Open your eyes and watch how you win.
Hey there! Are you sick of eating a sandwich with two hands?
No.
Then why not try out Disney's Handwich?
What the hell is that?
It's the sandwich you eat with only one hand.
Okay, but it looks like dog food.
Other sandwiches can be cumbersome and tricky with just one hand.
Was that me? Where did you get the footage of me?
So we took the best of a sandwich and put it into a small cone you can hold with one hand.
Hello, police? Someone's trying to sell me something.
Disney's Handwich, the sandwich of the future. Try one, or don't.
Yeah, that's 100% dog food. Not bad though.
New from the internet, it's 101 made-up stories about Tom Corless. You won't believe what people will say out of jealousy, envy, or even just to fit in. Inside, you'll find totally fabricated stories about Tom, such as he asks for his own private ride vehicles. He tripped a baby to cut them in line for Epcot 35th anniversary merchandise. He said Finding Nemo the Musical isn't coming back. That time he had an entire restaurant fired. He didn't save the country bears. He personally crashed the Disney Skyliner for clicks. He was the first person to steal a spork from Docking Bay 7. He stole the Buzzy animatronic. He personally TP'd Cinderella Castle in 2004. He popped the tires on parking trams every time Disney tried to bring them back sooner. He peeled the walls of the Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway queue. He killed Harambe, and many more. To read 101 made-up stories about Tom Corless, simply read Twitter today.
Delilah, did you get out of the boat then? Or the sub?
Yes, yes, I was already out of the boat.
Okay,
yes,
Delilah, Siobhan, and Tim Reck all got out of the sub. Well, Delilah was going and come.
I get dragged into this.
You get dragged.
You're gonna know Tim Reck.
Where can I?
very special episode of Ride Rehab watches.
Those two are staying in there in their submarines nice and tight.
Hang on, I'm not crazy. Okay.
Just roll the dice and follow me.
This is Captain Nemo speaking. Welcome aboard the Nautilus. We are proceeding on a course that will take us on a voyage 20,000 leagues under the sea.
I'm in the shot. Look at this. We have a TV. This is fancy. Thank you. Welcome back to News Tonight. We're live on YouTube. Please hit the like button. Please subscribe. And please check out what's happening this week on Disney Plus. Disney stock turning red. There you go. Also, let's see what's available this week at your local grocery store. Don't say Lay's barbecue. Oh, man. I like that he's on fire. That's nice. That's nice. Yeah, like Reggie Miller from downtown. Let's play some NBA Jam after NBA Jam. Hour six of the show is Pete and I playing NBA Jam. So stay tuned. Stay tuned for hour six. All right, it is time. Let's begin some March Madness.
That's right. We are here live back for 2022's WDWNT March Madness. I'm Eric Morton.
I'm Pete Carney.
And we'll be your hosts this evening. We have a number of epic matchups today, Pete.
You know what, Eric? We've had March Madness in the past, and I'm going to say this is the greatest year possibly ever where there might be some upsets we didn't see coming.
You're right, Pete. And this year's topic is going to be the best ride scenes at Walt Disney World. So all those scenes and stories you're used to, but there will not be a Cinderella story this year because...
She's not qualified.
She's not in the field.
This website may have been around for many, many years, but this is the 74th year of me doing this March Madness here at WWNT, and we cannot be more excited.
We have an amazing panel. I'm going to go over the ground rules, and then we'll preview some of these first matchups coming up.
Yes, and you know what? Maybe we should tell the panel to take their time, because a lot of the time at March Madness, this goes on way too short.
Not this
just,
year, Pete.
It's just such a short segment. And people don't really dive in. So maybe this year we can elaborate a little bit and really dig our claws into some of these matchups.
It sounds like you're starting to figure out why you're not on the panel and you're here in the studio.
I'm happy I'm next to you, my friend, and let's get into March Madness.
Well, hold on. Our illustrious panel will discuss each one of these matchups. They will be on a clock. They will be timed this year.
Stop the madness. There's a clock this year?
Viewers are welcome to influence the voters by form of super chat or bribery.
It sounds like the same to me. Am I right?
You are right, Pete.
Invisible cheers.
Invisible cheers to you, too. And with that, we're going to go down under the rotunda to see our illustrious panel led by Tom Corless.
I couldn't even get tickets to this.
You couldn't even, not even from secondhand, Pete? You didn't get any?
No, I could not.
I thought I saw you selling some outside.
I sold my own on accident.
Yeah, there you go. That's great. Well, welcome to March Madness. Let me introduce the panel for this year. We'll start down there. We have Lauren. Hello, Lauren. You can wave, yep, sure.
I didn't know what camera was on.
Lauren's filling in this week. Jill's gonna jump in next week. Colleen.
Hello. Oh, that was loud.
That was loud.
She came Nick. Like a wrecking ball.
Obviously, Nick is here. Nick. Miss Allison.
I'm here too, hello. Side.
Yeah, you are.
Desi. And our good friend Piano Rob is here.
Hey! Thank you for having me. Thank you for having me.
Tell everyone where they can find you on social media.
Oh, on Instagram and TikTok, Piano_Rob. And I have a Facebook, but just go to one of the other ones and I'll send it to you.
I don't really work here anymore because I don't have a job, but I love my friend Piano Rob. Anyway, back to you.
Is that an original piece?
That's something I've been working on for about 6-7 months.
That's good.
It's really coming
thank
along.
Thank you. Appreciate that.
It's coming along.
Rob wrote it.
Good thing Pete's stretching this out because it's going to be a short segment.
Why didn't you ask me to plug my social media? Come on.
Don't you have enough ads on this show?
Yeah. All right.
I think everyone here, did everyone come here tonight in Nick's maxi van?
Yeah.
I'm by surprised. Usually they don't get out.
By so. Choice? Is it by choice?
Sometimes.
Okay. Oh, boy. Okay, so like they said, 64 greatest ride scenes in the history of Walt Disney World, battling it out. The panel, they all get a vote. Let's get into it. Let's get started. What's the first matchup? What do we got? We've got the hitchhiking ghost scene, the original one, you know, not projected ghosts from the Haunted Mansion, against Snow White's Cottage from the Seven Dwarfs Mine Train. This is the first match. I say we get right into it. We'll show some video while the panelists are talking about these. But Lauren, why don't you start us off? Lawrence, I have to start.
Which one do you like? I'm going to be honest. I don't think I'm old enough to remember the original Hitchhiking Ghost. So this is already great.
They were physical. They were not projected.
I mean, I think Snow White's Cottage is just very cute, so I'm just going to go with that.
There you go. It's cute. Colleen.
I would go with the Hitchhiking Ghost, because that's more of a part of the story of the ride necessarily than the Snow White's Cottage, which is a very cute little thing as you're getting towards the end of the roller coaster. But the Hitchhiking Ghosts are iconic, and it was, you know, they were gonna follow you home.
Like Nick. Nick, which one are you taking?
So I'm going with the ghosts because they are a iconic park-specific attraction, right? Like the Snow White's Cottage is a beautiful show scene from an animated film, but the Hitchhiking Ghosts are just left an indelible mark on guests going to the park.
Sure. Miss Allison?
I agree with what Nick was saying. I think that it's unique to the Disney parks, the Hitchhiking Ghosts, and saying something for, you know, the original audio animatronics. And with Snow White's Cottage, you kind of, sometimes, like, I'll see it, but sometimes I kind of, like, go right past it and I can't even see it.
And if Allison sits on the left side, she can't even see it.
No, I can't. So, I mean, that's another reason why I don't really care for it.
Tell Lucas to sit on the other side.
Damn Lucas.
Desi.
When I was little, I used to be scared of the Hitchhiking Ghosts, and I thought they were really going to follow me home. So, Snow White.
Wow. All right. Wow. It's still better than any of Jason's arguments, which are always, is it at Epcot? Yeah. And that was the only, yeah.
I didn't see that one coming. But I'm going to tell you right now, you got one classic movie, you got one classic attraction.
If I want to see that scene in Snow White, I can watch Snow White. If I want to go see those ghosts, I can't anymore because they're gone. They're just a projection now. Hitchhiking Ghosts all the way.
Hitchhiking Ghosts. I'm going to take the ghosts as well. The ghosts have it.
Hey!
Ghosts have it.
Let's go.
Not till after 8 a.m.
Oh, okay.
Can I recount the votes? Isn't that, what is that, 4 to 5 to 2?
Yeah.
5 to 2.
I had such a good joke.
There you go. Bring me a pen. I don't have a pen. No, I don't need to borrow your pen.
What is it? Say it out
loud. I have my own. I have my own pens. I do have 1,000 pens. You can't touch those pens.
What was the score?
Other people can touch. Isn't it 5 to 2?
5-2, okay.
5-2, yeah. You can't talk about, no, we don't talk about Tom's pens? Yeah.
Next matchup.
Yeah, I got it, Pete. Thank you. We've got the Burning Rome scene from Spaceship Earth versus the Olaf intro scene from Frozen Ever After. Rob, why don't you start us off this time?
Oh, well, this one, I mean, I'm going Burning Rome all the way, I'm telling you, from the beginning. I can smell that right now. I can smell that. That is one of the most unique things Disney has. We can all smell that. I'm sure Olaf is cute, but this isn't about cuteness for me, so I'm going with Burning Rome.
It's actually a small fire in the back of the studio. It's normal. It's the, what is it, the smoking fridge back there? Desi.
I gotta go with the scent. I love that, the way that it brings in all of your senses, not just the visuals.
Yeah. Allison?
Yep. Burning Rome, there's a reason why they make candles that are scented to this. Scent is also...
Well, Disney doesn't make them.
Well,
people
saying,
on the internet make
that,
candles.
That it exists.
Disney accidentally makes them when they set up fireworks.
No, that's true. And scent, your sense of smell is the sense that's strongestly...
No. We are 40 minutes into the show.
It's more strongly linked to memory. Mm. Yeah. And that's why.
That's fair. Nick?
Has anyone ever wondered what Olaf might smell like? I'm going with Rome. Sense of smell over... Oh,
carrots, yeah, and good. Reindeer.
Yeah, right, probably, yeah. Mm. Rome.
Colleen?
I'm going to say Rome, too, as well. I had the same thought as Allison, is that people on the internet make candles based off the Rome on fire smell, yeah, which actually, when you think about it, is pretty strange.
Because it's just fire,
it's
right?
The smell of smoke. But I think...
Real smoke doesn't actually smell like that.
Similar to the hitchhiking ghosts, it's a park-specific, you know, scene, versus I can watch Olaf in many different forms on the internet if I would like to.
Pete and I had some Irish whiskey the other day that smelled like the burning Rome, right?
Hey, yeah. Delicious.
Yeah. Okay.
Lauren.
I'm going to say burning Rome.
Burning
I
Rome?
I mean, I think it's a cool scene. I feel like everyone just said it smells good. I think it's
everyone just talked about the smell. I also liked the part before it with the horse. I liked when they used to project the little cartoon.
I was going to say, we talked about the part that. When it worked.
Yeah. Well, it didn't. It was removed in the, it's actually removed in the 08 refurb, but I do miss that. I thought that was really cute. It's still a great scene. Like that backdrop is beautiful. The painted, you know, Roman city. It's a nice scene even before that, even before you get to the smell.
So, I think the smell's just so iconic and unique, yeah, in that you smell something. So our first, everyone's, yeah, first thought is, oh yeah, it smells like it's burning.
I just didn't want to go without mentioning like the more artistic part of the scene, right, but anyway.
It's generally, it's that's a good scene.
That's a 7-0 sweep. Seven?
Yes, yeah, seven.
I feel so like church, it felt like church. I don't know. Yeah, seven. Now a reading from the book of Mark Davis. What's, Jake, please give me the next matchup, please. Please. The underworld, the gangster scene of the great movie Ride up against Hell from Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. Hell also being up on this stage.
Oh.
Nick, why don't you start us off?
Yeah, good one right off the bat, because, I mean, Hell is just like this unexpected turn in a Disney dark ride in Fantasyland, right? But the gangster definitely wins this one just because, I mean, man, it solidifies what the great movie ride really is all about, right? Like, it's this interaction with the cast members and live show scenes, so it has to be the gangsters.
Colleen?
I really hope everyone at home is reading the crawl along the bottom of the screen. This is great. Yeah, this is hard. The only thing I remember really about Mr. Toad's Wild Ride is that you go to hell. Although now I'm looking at it and I'm like, I guess I don't
it's
remember
so
it.
Good.
I don't. But the gangster scene, I mean, the great movie ride was so detailed, and the gangster scene, as you just saw, you know, it looked so real, and all the little details and the great movie ride in its interaction and stuff. So I'm going to go with the gangster scene in the great movie ride. It was a great scene. That was a great ride.
It was very real. It looked just like the block where I grew up on in the Bronx.
It did.
We had someone named Muggsy next door. Lauren.
I'm going to go with Mr. Toad's Wild Ride. No, I've never ridden it, but I just think it's really funny that you can go to hell in a Disney park.
Mm. Have you been on Runaway Railway yet?
I've been on it.
It's close. It's close.
Once.
Rob.
I love both these rides, and I'm so sad I can't go and ride them at the moment. But this is an easy win, though. The underworld is such an amazing part of Great Movie Ride. I've had so many friends that have worked that role over the years. I absolutely adore it. That was the key attraction to that park. So it's definitely the underworld gangster scene.
Desi.
I love the interaction you have with the cast member during the underworld scene. And in my audition for WDWNT, I dressed up like Muggsy.
Allison.
I think it's one of the best attraction scenes and one of the best attractions of all time, which is the underworld. So that is why I'm going to be voting for the gangster scene.
I mean, everyone knows what I'm going to pick.
Mr. Toad.
Yeah, Mr. Toad. Yeah, sure. Gangster seat. I mean, how many ride scenes does the host of the attraction leave the vehicle because they're held up at gunpoint? And then you have a whole different host, and there's the whole bit where the car comes out and they're shooting across you, and I think it was a very exciting scene. I mean, obviously the hell scene, iconic, very memorable, but it's that gangster scene, though. So was that, is that 6-1? We had one yeah. Hell? Of course it was Laura.
Yeah.
6-1 for the Underworld. There you go. What's the next matchup? We have the pre-show of Dinosaur. This is like picking children. The pre-show of Dinosaur versus the pre-show of the original test track at Epcot.
How were they seated so far apart?
Yeah, that's...
Were they seated far apart?
Yeah, 4 and a 13.
Yeah. 4 and a 13, yeah. I mean, it kind of went by park. I don't know. Seating's not important.
Hell there.
There can only be one winner in the end anyway. Allison, why don't you start us off?
Okay, I mean, I have to go with the test track pre-show because that's where we get our seven. I mean,
just for that.
How could you not? I mean, even before I started working here, me and my one of my best friends that would go, we would also do seven to each other. So that's how much it sticks out in my mind, and I'm sure other people might do the same thing. So I'm going
for test
track.
Wasn't alive for this either.
No, I wasn't. It's tattooed on my arm, and I wasn't alive for it.
Desi?
I gotta go with Dr. Seeker. I love the hello there. It's so cute.
Yeah. Rob?
I love both of these pre-shows. The old test track pre-show is so good. John Michael Higgins, by the way, the actor is the one in that show.
Bill McKim.
I think it was a better ride, although I do like designing my vehicle now, but we'll go into that later. But the other pre-show is so iconic. I think we can all kind of recite most of the Dinosaur pre-show. I also love the little puppet and the hello there. That's one of the most iconic intros to a pre-show also. And I'm wearing the shirt today for that reason, so we're picking the Dinosaur pre-show.
There you go. Lauren?
I'm going with Dinosaur. I mean, I didn't know what the test track pretty show was until about 2 hours before the show when Jake explained it to me.
Did he even show her the video?
I've seen the video.
He also explained her what a fax machine was and a VHS.
A lot of things. Yeah, I mean, I do have the seven joke tattooed on my arm forever, but yeah, Dinosaur. It's one of my favorite rides, so that pre-show is iconic.
Colleen.
This is hard. They're both really iconic pre-shows, but I'm going to go with Test Track. I never really liked Dinosaur, so we didn't ride that as much. But also, Tom and I once reenacted the entire Test Track pre-show, and it was really fun. And so, I don't know. I remember that, so that one, I like that one better. It means more to me.
Nick.
If Dinosaur wins, Lauren, will you tattoo hello there on your, somewhere?
Sure.
All right, good.
If I can use my Expensify card, I will.
Yeah, there you go.
Really depends where you put that.
All right.
You know, I have to say Dinosaur. That is the one that I quote the most. If I didn't work here, like, I would never quote 257, I don't think. So... I, as much as I love that pre-show and it's really well done, Dinosaur is just the more fun one that sticks in your head, the quotes stay with you, Dinosaur.
Okay.
Yeah.
I mean, well, that solidifies it. It's 4-2.
Yeah.
I'm going to go with Dinosaur anyway.
Yeah.
I love the Test Track pre-show, but in Dinosaur, it's stuck around longer.
Yeah.
I think more people know it. I think if we're talking the best scenes of all time, this is one that's going to be in the conversation for years to come, right? So that's what we're arguing. Not our favorite, but what's the best, right? So I'm going to go with Dinosaur. So that's 5-2. 5-2 for Dinosaur. Okay, what's the next matchup? We have the Burning Town in Pirates of the Caribbean against the pre-show of the extraterrestrial alien encounter. More things Lauren's never seen. Lauren, let's put you on the spot. Which of these, one of these you've seen, which one do you like?
Well, Pirates of the Caribbean, I have seen the pre-show because you've made me watch it more than once. More than once.
Sounds about right.
But Pirates of the Caribbean is iconic. Like, there's arguably fewer things that are more Disney than Pirates of the Caribbean. And this scene, and they're singing Yo-Ho, like Pirates Life for me, like it's just a more Disney scene.
Yeah, one of these attractions does still exist. So
yeah,
it's a
well,
fair,
yeah.
It's a fair argument. Colleen?
Oh, yeah, I'm also gonna go with Pirates. I did do Alien Encounter, but I don't remember it, other than it was terrifying. But yeah, Pirates is iconic, and you know what I love about Pirates, and I mean a lot of the older attractions, is like there's something everywhere you look, and especially that scene, you're in this huge room, and it's so theatrical, and there's all the forced perspective, and it goes up so high, and it's a really great, iconic scene and an iconic ride.
Nick?
Yeah. This is the hardest one so far. No, really, really. Yeah.
No, I get it.
I for every reason that Colleen really just said, it is theatrical. Pirates is theatrical. I that was one of the first scenes I wrote down on my paper when we were coming up with what goes in here. You know, it's funny because I didn't even think about the pre-show because I wasn't thinking much about pre-shows. But when you brought this up, I'm going to vote the upset here. I'm going to vote Alien Encounter because of how well written it was. It was a good, it was a very, very good pre-show. I'm not even 100% convinced that that Burning Town scene is the best part of Pirates of the Caribbean. So I'm going to go with pre-show Alien Encounter.
Arguably, more people are going to bring up the scene after, right?
Yeah.
The jail cell, right?
Yeah.
But I'm gonna echo Nick. I think because of how well written,
that scene has to be my pick. Yeah.
It was brilliant. This evil corporation. And it's funny coming from Disney.
Nah.
But this evil corporation, and it's beautifully done. This whole thing is cute. And sort of denouncing what Disney is, right, about these cute characters. And it's this cute character, and it's like, oh, not only am I going to fry this cute character, I'm going to murder him at some point.
Right?
Like, this is, he does. the process can be suspended indefinitely, and Skippy's gone.
Yeah.
You don't know where Skippy went at that point. But this is, and of course, Tim Curry as Sir is incredible. So
well written.
Alien Encounter pre-show for me, obviously Pirates is amazing, but this is such an underrated scene. And this is the best part of Alien Encounter. The main show was not great. This is the scene in Alien Encounter that defines the attraction. Allison?
As a child, I was too afraid to go on Alien Encounter, so I never actually went on it.
It's almost as if that's why it closed.
I was too scared to go on it, so I don't have any real connection to it. But the Burning Town with Pirates, it's such a great mix of how it's a scary situation. The pirates are burning the town, but yet it's very humorous at the same time.
Yeah.
So I like how they kind of are able to find the humor and the fun and the mischief all in the same time in this very large, grand scene. So I am going to be picking the Burning Town.
Desi?
I appreciate how we're sticking to this countdown clock.
I just looked at it. I was like, oh, there's a clock.
Yeah, the Alien Encounter, I only went on it like once or twice because it was just too scary for me, so Pirates.
I don't think, there's some guy gets eaten. It's not a big deal.
Too scary?
Rob.
That ride is awesome. That was fantastic. It's probably the number one attraction in Disney history to make little kids cry.
You watch the
poor cast members have to release these families. I love it. That is an excellent attraction. We have other pirate scenes on this bracket, don't we?
We do.
Then you want to know what? I am going to go with Alien Encounter.
Didn't help, Doc. Thank you. I appreciate that Alien got to put up a fight. It's good. 4-3, though, for the Burning Town. But a good fight was put up. All right, let's try to stick to the clock on the next one. We're gonna try this, folks. What's the next match? All right, we've got the arts scene from the original Journey into Imagination versus the cockpit. When you enter the cockpit for the first time on Millennium Falcon, Smuggler's Run. Rob, why don't you start us off?
This one's a little easier for me than I thought. I love this scene from Journey into the Imagination. It is beautiful. But in my opinion, the best thing about Smuggler's Run is your first
entrance into that cockpit. If you are a Star Wars fan, there is just a feeling you get when you walk in there. I'm not as thrilled with the attraction itself, but that feeling you get the first time you walk in the cockpit, I'm going with that.
Desi?
So for the same reason that Rob said that he wasn't going to necessarily vote for the pirate scene because there was a better pirate scene on the list, there's a better Figment scene on the list, and I am just a huge Star Wars fan, so I got to go with Smuggler's Run.
Wow, Allison.
I haven't seen that art scene, obviously, in person in a very, very long time, but one I remember going on this when I was a child, I remember the introduction with the Dreamfinder and the art scene. This scene was absolutely so beautiful, and as this little kid watching it change colors is just so magical and beautiful. There's no way.
Why stick laughing? It's why are you laughing?
Is it the scroll?
Oh, you read the scroll? Can we focus on the segment?
Yeah.
The arts. I have to go with the arts.
The arts, thank you. I'm also going to go with the arts because that Walter Paragoy animal carousel has haunted me my entire life. And it's a beautiful scene. Nick.
Millennium Falcon cockpit. Wow. It gave me those Star Wars feels, and as good as the art scene is,
it doesn't.
I can't.
It's 3-2 for the cockpit.
Cockpit.
I'm gonna say the cockpit as well. I don't remember the original Journey to the Imagination. But I think, like Rob said, walking into the cockpit is the best part of that ride. Because you're like, I'm here, wow.
Yeah.
Is it 3-3 now, is that right?
Yeah.
No, it's
4-2. So it doesn't even matter, but Lauren, go ahead.
Oh, okay, perfect. Well, I would just like to make one point because I'm only here tonight. I watched a video of the art scene, obviously I was not alive. And I don't see the difference between that and Runaway Railway.
Oh,
whoa.
It's a white room that you put lights on. Wait, so.
Is Lauren getting escorted off the stage?
Lauren's not even going to finish the round. Never mind
get
the show.
Out of the studio.
It's a white room that you put lights on. I like lights.
I'm
a lighting technician. But I just wanted to make that point that I don't see the difference between that and Runaway Railway.
Wow.
That being said, Smuggler's Run, because I think that that's such a like insane thing to be able to pilot the Millennium Falcon and see the like walking into it is a big
5-2
deal.
5-2, the cockpit of the Millennium Falcon over my childhood. Great. All right, next. The next matchup. What do we got? We've got the pre-show of the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror versus the Hydrolators from the Living Seas. I haven't started us off yet. I'll start us off. This is really difficult because the Hydrolators were amazing to the point at which people always asked, are we actually going anywhere? But then it is up against one of the greatest pre-shows ever put together. That library is super detailed and the lights go out and this film is perfection. The voiceover work it evokes the Twilight Zone perfectly. It's beautiful. I'm going Twilight Zone pre-show. Lauren?
I'm going Tower of Terror.
There you go. Colleen?
I'm Tower of Terror. I don't remember the Hydrolators.
Yeah. I mean, I echo everything Tom said. So Twilight Zone, Tower of Terror.
Allison?
Yeah. It's not. Tower of Terror.
We can make up some time here.
Perfect.
There you go.
Desi.
I was so upset when the Hydrolators lost out in the first round last year for the ride vehicles.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And I don't want to go with the sweep, so I'm going Hydrolators.
There you go. Rob?
It was sweet. The Hydrolators were fun, except when they didn't work and then you just walk into the building it was nothing when you got used to the other thing. The Tower of Terror scene is awesome. You get that. You get Fraud Serling there in it, which it does a
Rod
great
Serling.
Job.
Fraud
No, it's Fraud Serling. It's not the real one. It's Fraud.
His voice is perfect.
But he does a great job. That's Mark Silverman. Fantastic pre-show, and you got all the little Twilight Zone trinkets in that room too.
Yeah.
So definitely that one.
There you go, 6-1, thanks to Desi. We got one more in this bracket, I believe. Yes. Oh boy, I believe this was called butt stuff in a previous week, but the bugs exiting, and it's tough to be a bug under your behind. against the elephant bathing pool from the Jungle Cruise. Rob, why don't you start us off?
Oh, okay. Both iconic, I guess, in their own way. But the thing I like best that. About, because let's face it, Tough to Be a Bug gets a lot of flack for a lot of reasons.
Yeah.
But the end of that show, there's always somebody in that audience that is not expecting it, and you always get the reaction. So I'll go with It's Tough to Be a Bug.
Wow. Desi.
That part creeps me out, so I'm going to go with the bathing elephants.
I'm
going to
guess all the women on the panel are going to pick not the bug scene, but that Allison. Oh no, Allison likes bugs.
I do like bugs.
That's right.
I'm not picking it though.
These ones don't paint, so.
I mean, it's hysterical because I like to go into that theater and like sit near like this like group of people that like you kind of know what's gonna happen. Yeah. They're like, oh, these are gonna be the ones that are gonna scream.
You gotta sit near the people that look like they're gonna freak out. Yeah.
As hilarious as that is, I love the elephant bathing pool. I'm going with that one.
Okay, Lauren.
I'm actually gonna go with It's Tough to Be a Bug. I just think the lighting in it is very cool.
All right.
I don't know. I think the Jungle Cruise, sometimes they don't make the joke, and it just doesn't always hit, and I don't know. Okay. It's not the best scene in the Jungle Cruise, so.
Colleen?
Yeah, this is hard, weirdly, because it's Tough to Be a Bug. That part is really funny when people in the audience scream. And then the Jungle Cruise is really iconic. But I think I'm going to go with the bugs exiting.
Wow.
Shannon hates that ride with a fiery passion.
So just to spite you.
And it's hysterical. She, like, is standing already. Like, she's so ready to, like, don't let bugs touch me. It's really funny.
So out of spite, okay.
Yeah.
Some of the best decisions in March Madness are often made.
Yeah.
Nick.
Not even close. The fact that Disney decided to put, you know, this bug effect under people's butts.
This isn't happening.
Is oh my the greatest God. Thing.
This isn't happening.
The yes. elephant baby pool, iconic,
this
great.
This is
whatever,
not real.
Blah, 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 blah.
This is so good.
But a better show wanted. Scene to
this is what
add
I
excitement
oh, wait, hold on.
Into the theater. The bugs.
No, he is picking
the bugs.
Yes,
100% is a better show scene.
What?
It's not
Mark Davis's Indian bathing pool.
Mark Davis should have put bugs on the boats.
I don't know if you've been on it recently.
Somebody
would have
jumped on it.
Sometimes they get on when the boat sinks. They just kind of come in.
The leeches.
You mean vloggers?
That's it. That's
same thing. I'm picking, for Mark Davis, I'm picking the bathing pool. I can't, but it doesn't even matter. The bug scene has won.
Yeah.
Butt
yeah.
stuff is going in the next round. I don't believe this. All right.
Again.
Pete and Eric, up to you in the atrium.
Holy smokes. Eric, can we talk about what just happened here? I mean, we had what I thought would be a very stereotypical round. Everything seemed to be going the right direction, but that last
incredible,
pick.
Pete. Sometimes you're the windshield, and sometimes you're the bug. But sometimes, every now and then, the bug breaks the windshield. And a stunning upset, if you ask
me.
I
mean, I guess I should get it. I mean, bathing here in Florida does seem optional. But a couple takeaways. I wrote some things down. Apparently, people would rather be followed home than just have someone knock at their front door. Snow White versus the Hitchhiking Ghost. What else do you have? I saw you have some notes as well.
Yeah, no, I just have, the AVP matchup was big, Alien versus Pirate. And that ended, you know, a
huge,
lot of people terrified by that Alien. The Pirate was great. Skippy doing his little Mike TV routine from Willy Wonka was, you know, not enough to get
love
him over
that.
The top.
Also, I love that a lot of the panel loves sock puppets, which is a big deal. Who would have thought a sock puppet could take you to the next round?
We used to have some of our own right here in the studio.
It
Pete.
Used to be a real
God
thing.
Knows where
it
they are.
It was unbelievable. Also, we looked at some of the, apparently some people were worth smelling for, where Olaf got destroyed by Burning
Room.
Oh,
my God. We finally found out from Burning Room what happens to snowmen in summer.
In Rome.
Yeah,
yes.
In Rome especially.
Yikes.
You know what, Pete? I've always wanted to see what happens if you drink a green beer on a green screen. Water, Mom.
Yeah, me too.
Cheers to you. That was an amazing first round.
It was. You know what? Yo-ho, yo-ho. I also discovered that some people would rather be pillaged than invaded, which is a weird choice.
And is it really that tough to be a bug?
And instead of using your imagination, not in space, We want not Star Wars, we want Star Peace. You know what I'm saying?
Let's do it, Star Peace. Look, we've got a lot more action to go to.
There's
next.
More?
We're gonna go back down under the rotunda and see what happens in this next round.
I can't
round.
Wait, this is gonna be intense.
Great, thank you. Some of the panel is missing as they look for a pen for me. So that's what's happening currently. Looking for a pen.
I have 19 more things I wrote down.
Did you find Allison?
Aren't nearly
Allison
as good.
Went to find a pen. Allison, come back.
I
All right, cool.
A Sharpie and a pencil.
I'll take them. Thank you. Some applause for Allison. She tried.
I tried to find you a pen.
She tried. Lauren, you succeeded. You don't get applause.
That's fine.
Only when you don't succeed in this company do you get applause. All right, we have more matchups. Let's do it. What's up next? Oh, Super Chats. Hold on. We have Super Chats. I cannot read those from back here tonight.
What the? Oh.
No, hold on. Someone try to read. Go back one.
Chuck Schofield. Gay. Well, for $4.99.
Well, Rosita sent us $100. Thank you, Rosita. We appreciate it. I can read that one. 68 SPC, $20.
Says thanks for the hat.
Oh, we sent him the hat. Yeah, he's been asking for a hat for a long time. Chuck sent us $9.99.
Watching everything lose to Dreamfinder will be fun.
Aww, yeah.
We can only hope, but based on what just happened with Bugs, I don't know.
Rosie sent us $4.99.
Colleen will read them.
Chuck sent another $4.99. Come on, hell. Look at my profile pic with original set pieces from that scene.
Oh, yeah, he's with the devil.
And great news crawl on the bottom. Iconic for the win, WDW Mickey for $2. This is amazing, Adam, for $10.
That's it.
Woo!
Thank you, Colleen.
You're welcome.
I usually can't read it from the desk. I'm even further back tonight. Okay, next matchup. Let's go. Big Al, his whole scene from the Country Bear Jamboree against the Anubis scene of the Great Movie Ride. Rob, start us off.
Oh, all right. This is a rough one. We all know there's blood on the saddle. Turning
they
red.
They both have blood. These yeah, two scenes.
They remade it in Turning Red. I think that's what they're doing. Anubis on the Great Movie Ride, though, man. A great movie ride. That it's such an immersive ride. I know this is such a classic show as well. This is a rough one, but I'm gonna go with Anubis on Great Movie Ride. That's a fantastic scene.
All right, Desi. Allison?
God, I have, this was really tough for me. I don't even have anything marked down. Can you skip me?
No.
Oh.
Nick's the host now.
God, I think that what you said when we came up with these, how you were talking about how you know everything about the character in just such a short amount of time just by looking at him, I think that might have convinced me to go with Big Al, because I think you're right. It takes a special sort of imagineering to be able to do that. So I'm gonna go with Al.
Can you skip me?
No. Just say no to him.
No.
No, Nick, no, we can't.
See
skip
how mean
you.
She is.
That wasn't mean. Always.
Meanest person on staff.
So untrue.
Ooh. Oh. Ouch. You know, man. I'm talking like
can't imagine right here, why we can never get done in the 3 minutes.
No, this one is super hard, and that's why they're like 9-8, right? Man, Anubis is so good. All right, I'm just going with my initial Anubis.
Your initial Anubis.
Yes, that was my initial thought. Sorry, Big Al, I feel bad.
Colleen?
Anubis.
I'm gonna go with Anubis as well. Like Tom said, how often do you go on a ride and then your host leaves and you get hijacked, but then your hijacker is murdered and your host comes back?
I mean, it happens at SeaWorld sometimes, but it's not part of the actual attraction.
Wow.
And how do you not pick the interaction with a cast member versus an animatronic?
That's
a fair point. Lauren?
Honestly, I don't think either of these are the best scenes in either of the rides.
Oh,
wow.
But I will say Anubis over Country Bear Jamboree, just in general.
I'm sorry, Big Al, I can't save you this time. But I am picking Big Al, because like I did say, Allison reminded me. Again, it's brilliant. You know everything you need to know about him in the few seconds he's up there, which is brilliant storytelling. But I mean, Anubis is a great scene, but I'm picking Big Al. All right, we did it in the time limit. How about that?
All right.
Woo! Anubis over Big Al. Next one. We have Brava Centauri from Horizons. Look it up, kids. And the montage from the end of The American Adventure. Nick, knew it, so I'm putting you. I have to go first. I wanted to put you on the spot.
Man, that American Adventure, it gives me the feels. But I have to say, Horizons.
I think he said Horizons.
I'm voting Horizons here. I think that is the better show scene. God, that song is so good, but the better show scene is Horizons.
I know there's no words to it, but I mean the score in this scene, no slouch either.
You're right,
right.
You're 100% right.
Into space.
Yeah.
Colleen?
I don't remember Horizons, so I think I just have to go with American Adventure because that's the one that I know. I mean, know what Lauren is going to say.
Well, I'm not saying it just because I never went on Horizons. I think that the American Adventure, like the montage, is a great show scene, so that's what I'm going with.
The kids love Beyonce.
Beyonce. Wow.
Oh, man. Well, one of these scenes I have taken numerous naps in over the years. And the other one is probably the greatest freaking ride in Epcot history. So we're going to make this very simple. Pete, by the way, thank you for dressing like Duff Killigan from Kim Possible today.
You're very well.
And we are picking Horizons 100%. Horizons.
The Kim Possible World Showcase Adventure did not make.
Just barely, though.
That's why I'm
just
here
barely. I love some of those phone scenes were real engaging, though.
I like that.
On that Verizon
it's a great call out.
Desi.
Verizon.
One of these just gives me more feels, so I got to go with America.
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 Wow. It's not even
nice. Allison?
I tear up or cry every time I see that montage. I mean, I love that scene from Horizons, but I am moved emotionally from the American Adventure, so that's my vote.
Ooh, all tied up.
Oh, boy. We know where this is going.
These are both fantastic, and the music's a big part of both of them. That Into Space score is haunting. It's really nice. And those show scenes are giant. But the American Adventure, I mean, it's a very nice montage, but it is a scream, right? And the song is wonderful. The song's the best part of that. Absolutely. But I think Horizon, that combination of the music, those giant sets. Also, there was a kid named Tommy who lost his shoe in space, so I got to go. I got to go with Horizons. We're going with Brava Centauri.
What did you guys vote for?
American Adventure.
Is it not?
Americas.
I'm just going by what's up there. Did they miscount? How many Americas are there?
There was four.
Were there four Americas? You're wrong back there. Switch that.
I was so excited for a second.
Don't be mean to
we
Jake.
Miscounted. It's typical in Florida. It's fine.
we have to count them
again. We just round it up.
So my vote didn't matter. All right, next matchup. Great.
So what it won?
What?
American Adventure.
America won, of course.
Oh, thank God.
American Adventure. Fake out.
We have to commentate
it's like
later.
The Oscars. What's the next one? The finale of Muppet Vision 3D against the ballroom of the Haunted Mansion. Miss Allison, why don't you start us off?
I think that the ballroom for the Haunted Mansion might take it all. So I am definitely going for the ballroom Haunted Mansion.
Well, Desi?
I'm also going for the ballroom of Haunted Mansion. I know that there are a lot of Haunted Mansion scenes on here, and the ballroom happens to be my favorite one.
Rob?
Ooh, I'm going to go with the ballroom, too. It's the most classic. But let's give this Muppet Vision finale at least a little bit of the benefit here. It's a beautiful finale. I think it's probably the best 3D show that Disney's done, but we're going with the ballroom.
You got a minute and a half. Yet it's tough to be a bug is going on to the next round. Lauren.
Okay. I had to check and make sure that there's a Muppet Vision 3D
you
scene
to make sure
later
there's another
on
one? Yeah.
Because I would die for the Muppets, but like you can't beat the ballroom scene. Like it's iconic. It's the one that everyone remembers, the Pepper's ghost effects and like.
Yeah, that's already 4-0. But Colleen, go ahead.
I mean, the ballroom. It's Pepper's Ghost is such this old theater effect, and just you see it used so well in this ride, and I think it speaks volumes to like practical effects and look what you can do without projections and screens, and it's my favorite part of the Haunted Mansion, and you know, I'm always looking at different parts and trying to watch, you know, all of one little section because there is so much going on, and I like that, like, the animatronics get like retired to like that scene in the Haunted Mansion because there's like animatronics. Like the grandmother is like an old animatronic of the grandmother from like Carousel of Progress.
Yeah.
And I think that's funny that they go to the Haunted Mansion to die.
All right.
That's kind of the story.
Yeah.
Nick?
I know this doesn't matter, but it's weird that both of these are seated where they are. I think they should be higher up, but.
I think the Muppet Vision pre-show got a much higher seat.
True.
I think that was why.
Man, yeah, that ballroom at number six, that's gonna go far there. Because I'm gonna have to vote for that too, even over Muppets, because it is just a better scene in this matchup. As bad as I'd want that Muppet Vision finale to do something in this tournament, I can't vote for it here. There's so much going on with that ballroom scene.
I'm throwing in a pity vote for the Muppet finale. I love how much is going on in the room at that point. Like Statler and Waldorf are like surrendering and Bean Bunny's lighting up the fireworks and then Swedish Chef's coming from the back and blowing the whole place up and Sweetums comes out and there's stuff on the screen. It's not just a 3D show, right? Mm-hmm. There's stuff happening all around you. So at least a shout out to the Muppet Vision finale, but it is 6-1 for the Bull. Next match. We have the blue light tunnel from Space Mountain up against the Yeti when it worked from Expedition. I have to preface that, when it worked from Expedition Everest. Nick, why don't you start us off?
This is messed up. The blue light
tunnel. I always
tunnel.
Just look for whoever looks the least certain about the decision.
No, not even. No uncertainty
here. Oh, really?
Blue light tunnel
okay.
doesn't even deserve to be in this tournament.
Wow.
Does Agreed. Not even deserve a place at the table. The Woo! Yeti is swiping that blue light tunnel right out of the bracket.
Yeah. Colleen?
The Yeti, you know? Even not working, it's still freaky.
Yeah.
I'm pretty freakier that it's not moving and there's just a strobe on it.
That's true, too. But yeah, it's, you know, the Yeti.
Light
Lauren, which strobe light do you like better?
The blue one.
No, when it works, you said.
Well,
you said
it
works.
I have never been on Expedition Everest while the Yeti worked. I was never tall enough when it opened, and then the Yeti broke like 2 seconds later, so. I mean, Disco Yeti's been there every time I've ridden it. I've never seen it work. One of these works, so it's obviously the better show scene.
If the Yeti is working,
yeah, my man,
I'm taking the Yeti. Because it was the only reason for this ride to exist, because the rest of it is garbage.
No,
but
stop
it. It's just a roller coaster. It was the only good thing about it. It was the only scene where it's like, that's amazing. And then that broke, and I just don't even want to go
the
on
hair
it anymore.
Hairband scene? Come on.
The hairband scene? No, that
Falcon?
Was Food Rocks.
Hey, it's not time for the commentary yet.
Food Rocks had hairband.
We were going to jump out of this studio and come back to a celebration.
You guys are not supposed to talk when we don't have the camera over there, you know? Yeti, Allison.
Oh, I was fortunate enough to be able to go on Expedition Everest when the Yeti worked.
Were you tall enough?
First of all, mister.
She's tall enough now?
I was tall enough then. I don't know, what year was it?
2006.
Yeah, I was an adult. I was an adult. I was the same height.
Are any of us adults now?
No.
Not to get existential during March Madness.
It's liquid madness.
But when I saw all the advertisements, it really hyped you up, and you were like, oh, okay, like, you know, I'll believe it when I see it. And then when you're waiting for it, and then you go, and it feels like it's so close to you, and I saw it, I was like, whoa, and I like, it was blew my mind. Yeah. So Yeti all the way.
Desi?
I have to agree with Nick. I don't know why this blue light tunnel is even on the list
right.
compared to some of the other
things.
There are
a lot of Kmart fans.
So Yeti.
Get the joke.
Wow.
Well done.
Well, I don't know why the Yeti's not working, That's first of all, because it's awful. But I think the other awful thing about that ride is why build half a mountain. Like, I don't understand. We could see half a mountain from half of Disney World.
Yeah.
But just for fun, I'm saying the blue light tunnel.
Get out of here, Rob.
Oh, boy. So there you go, 5-2 for the Yeti.
Yeti or not.
Life on the farm from Living with the Land versus the Star Destroyer Hangar Bay from Star Wars Rise of the Resistance. Rob.
Ah.
People are just yelling Hangar Bay in the crowd.
I know.
Hangar Bay.
I mean,
does the Illuminati live in the Hangar Bay? Tell me that.
Turn around the tunnel.
Living with the Land is fantastic, but let's be honest. It's got to be the Hangar Bay. Rise of the Resistance is definitely in the top couple rides in the world probably ever made. So we're going to pick the Hangar Bay with Rise of the Resistance.
Desi.
It takes my breath away when I
The barn?
That mailbox.
The dog.
It has an 82 on it. I'm always speechless. How did this survive? Does JPEG know this is there?
Are there gators on the right?
Does he know fruit isn't an IP?
So people have picked based on registers, boats in the past. I'm picking everything based on Star Wars, so hang on.
Wow.
That's how times have changed. Allison.
I mean, life on the farm is absolutely adorable, but when you look at the Hangar Bay, I mean, there's no comparison. I mean, look at that footage. I don't know.
The chicken and the stormtrooper move about the same amount.
They
both just go like this.
The chicken does crow, though.
It does make noise.
It does make noise.
It's an advantage chicken.
I know.
There you go. I'm picking Life on the Farm. I like another scene in Rise better than this one. So I don't know. I like the farm. I think it's iconic. Not only is it an iconic scene from the attraction, it's an iconic scene from Garden Grill. From Garden Grill, you get a whole different vantage point. And they built that bedroom upstairs. And the only place you could see it from is if you eat at Garden Grill. And I just think it was so thoughtful. And it's a great, charming scene. And the Hangar Bay is really big, but there's no movement in it. I hate this, how static it is. I don't like that. So, Nick.
So, I think... No.
I like it.
I have all this time
like
to think. All right, I have 37. I got to leave time for you guys. Oh my goodness. I can't believe this. Am I going with Life on the Farm with Living with the
Land?
No.
Because
you're not a Star Wars fan.
There's projectors in buffaloes.
Oh, the Star Wars
in the buffalo.
See, but the charming scene. Star Wars Hangar Bay.
Oh, come on.
There you go.
Yeah.
Ooh, great choice.
Yeah.
Change that score. He changed his mind.
Hangar Bay.
I'm going to go with the Hangar Bay as well.
Yeah.
And I want to say, for me, it's almost how it starts. You expect to go out different doors than what you go out of the ship. Like
that's a different scene.
That's a different scene.
But then it's like that's already so you're already a little bit surprised, and then you walk in, and it is like
it's pretty amazing. It really is.
And yeah, they don't move, but it's still like wow, they're there. They're physically there. It could have been worse.
It could have been, Lauren.
I'm going with the Hangar Bay because how many of these ride scenes can you go and walk around in? Mm. And like, yeah, there's.
I mean, you could walk around in the farm scene. You may not get to stay in the park, but.
I mean, yeah. I guess.
I mean, that lady took a cucumber. I think she still can go. I don't know.
That's fair, but yeah, the Hangar Bay.
How scared would we be if the boat turned that corner to the barn and like dozens of chickens were just lined up facing the boat, just staring at us?
It's like a scene out of Zelda.
Are you saying if it was like a chicken Hangar Bay?
Yeah, that'd be insane.
Then we would have picked it.
Yeah. That's we would have picked it.
I would have picked it if it was just a bunch of chickens.
Rob the voice
that
of reason.
Surprised the crap out of me.
All right, what's next? What do we got? We have The Mine from Seven Dwarfs and Mine Train and The Renaissance from Spaceship Earth, both capturing important moments in world history. Lauren. Lauren, what are you?
Both involve ceilings.
I have to say the Renaissance. For no reason other than, I don't know, the mind just isn't that great to me.
Okay.
Because you go through it, and then it's just the same thing. Like, the entire time you're going through the mine, it's exactly the same as when you entered the mine. There's like the first, like, ooh, ah, it's cool, and then it is the same exact thing.
Well, there are seven of them. So
seven.
Still Michelangelo. Yes.
Wow. No, but it's cool, and it's history, and it's learning, and I don't know. I just don't like the mine scene that much, so.
Colleen.
I'm going to say the Renaissance as well. I always thought the dwarves' faces were weird. And it was, you know, the beginning of doing that technology.
I don't know if you can say that.
And they were strange to me. But the Renaissance theme is really iconic. And, yeah.
Nick.
You know, every time we go through that Renaissance scene, it's always the same paintings and sculptures. They never progress. You figured they'd get somewhere by now. So because of that, I'm going with the seven dwarfs. They're making progress in society. They're making money, turning the economy.
But they don't actually mine any more jewels.
Oh,
in
it's coming
rides.
Out there. I see the carts going by and the jewels coming out. Yeah, they're making a real difference with the economy.
They work for a rebus.
I mean, art is important. I get it, but we need to mine those jewels. So mine train.
I'm going with mine train also. I think it's one of the best stage scenes. I think there's a lot of old school type gags, the skunk thing, and. The teetering jewels. I like the scene a lot. I think it feels like old school Disney, but with modern animatronics. Yeah. And I think it's a really well staged scene. Allison?
This is one of my favorite scenes from Spaceship Earth, is the Renaissance. I love the one before this one. I like the music much better. Are we picking a specific version or no? Not really.
No.
Oh, okay.
Because it really was just music.
Yeah, so I mean, I love the music. Okay. I love, you know, it's a nice big scene. There's a lot of stuff going on. Picking the Renaissance scene.
Desi?
I'm going to pick Seven Dwarves only because I want Rob to be the tiebreaker.
Wow. Lucky for you, this is pretty easy for me because there is so much to look at in the Renaissance scene. You got the hidden Mickey with the glue. And I do agree that there is two major changes for me that would have made this even more of a landslide for me to pick the Renaissance is Jeremy Irons saying the Renaissance.
The Renaissance.
He said it amazingly. And I missed the statue nudity. We had some statue nudity that was changed.
We didn't say which
room.
Version of the scene. You want to take the 94 one?
But Renaissance. So the jewels are great, but the Renaissance scene is fantastic. It's iconic.
94 best version of Spaceship Earth. No one's going to argue on that.
Yes.
4-3.
All right, what's up next? We have the crash scene from the original test track against the jail scene from Pirates of the Caribbean. Rob, why don't you start us off, because Desi was mean to you then.
The crash scene in Test Track is fantastic. It made that part of the ride amazing. It is good. I appreciate it. But come on, let's be honest. The other ones is a million times better. That's the most, we all whistle at that dog. Everybody has that image in their head. They had to put it in the movie. It's the jail scene.
Desi.
I love the jail scene, if for no other reason than it's the logo for Locked In with Eric Morton.
Yeah.
Allison.
I love the original crash, you know, just looking at the crash cars. I don't know, it's really well done, but I'm gonna have to use the word iconic for this one, for Pirates of the Caribbean, Dog with the Keys.
Drink.
Yeah, this is the one, right? This is the scene from Pirates this is the iconic scene, the Dog with the Keys. So much so that it's one of the few things that directly in the movie is there. That dog is never going to move. It's a wonderful part. Definitely Pirates. Nick?
Yeah, it doesn't need much explanation. I mean, that jail scene probably can be used in classes to show people, this is what a show scene needs to look like in an attraction at a theme park.
Great staging. When it doesn't matter, it translates to every language, right? It doesn't matter what language you're speaking. You see that scene, it translates. The comedy translates. Colleen?
Pirates. Absolutely.
Lauren?
I don't like a lot of things, but that dog is my favorite Disney character.
Yeah.
Like, I don't care about a lot of things, but that dog I would die for.
I agree.
So,
I agree.
Jail scene.
I would chain myself to that dog.
Sweet.
Might have to in the next couple of years. Who knows?
No. Don't say that.
And we're on.
Who knows anymore?
Stop.
All right. One more in this bracket. Let's go. The squid attack from 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea against the finale of Avatar Flight of Passage. Nick.
I hate you, Tom. no, I mean, look, I how the heck did we see this at 16? The squid.
Because people weren't alive for it.
Yeah, okay,
it's just
whatever.
A squid.
I mean, it's Flight of Passage. I can't not vote for that. But
that's why this is a 16 and that's a 1.
Okay, whatever. But I mean, the squid deserves to go farther. Sorry, squid. But Flight of Passage, I mean, that's such a well-written scene, emotional, well-animated. It's also a screen-based scene that we're voting for when we're all like, stop doing screens. But I mean, in this case, we have to vote for it.
Proof that it can be done, though, right?
When done right,
you can still feel
it
things.
Elicit emotion, right?
Yeah. Screens have a place, and sometimes it's that, right? Colleen?
It's like, I feel sad in a way because I know that I rode 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, but I don't remember it. There's been a lot of things where I'm like, I know I wrote all these things, but I don't remember it. And I wish I did and, you know, could have a better formed opinion. But yeah, Flight of Passage. I remember when we were, you know, ranking attractions earlier in the last year, whatever. And it was like, this is breathtaking. So yeah, Flight of Passage.
Lauren?
Flight of Passage is beautiful. This is obvious. I mean, this is the best scene in it. I've taken a bunch of people on this ride, and I've never seen someone not smiling, having, like, enjoying themselves during this scene. Like, it's stunning. It's so much fun. The movements with it, it's great. The other thing's just a squid. Like, Tom will go put the costume on.
Yes, I'm only a squid.
Tom will go put the costume on. It's, like, the same thing. Like, it's just a squid.
It is.
Rob, if you want to bring the piano next week and sing instead of me, that'd be...
I'm enjoying this.
Rob, go ahead.
I know Flight of Passage is beautiful, the colors are beautiful, but it makes me dizzy, and the banshee breathing between my legs is kind of weird, and I kind of miss 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea. That was a great ride that was there. As a kid, I really enjoyed it. Yeah, it had to go. It did its time. I don't think it's going to get many other votes. I'm going to throw the squid my vote.
Desi.
I mean, Flight of Passage, it gave me so many feels the first time I rode it, and I didn't even like the Avatar movie.
Nobody liked the Avatar.
I was waiting for it.
So yeah, Flight of Passage.
Allison.
I mean, you definitely get this really amazing, serene feeling at the end of Flight of Passage, but when I was a child on 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, and you're in that little tight compartment, and you're already like kind of tight and, you know, a little claustrophobic, and all of a sudden now the squid comes out of nowhere and is now like, you feel
up
so
in your face.
Feel so vulnerable, like being in there, and now the squid's there. It like really kind
squid's
of
squid's there breathing between your legs.
And yeah. Did you get braces?
Yes, I did.
Oh. When did that happen?
This week.
Oh, I just
wow.
noticed it.
Thanks, everyone.
One time, bring it up.
Sorry, Allison, I'm trying to better myself. Excuse me.
I just noticed it. I was like, wait a second.
She's definitely not the meanest person on set.
She proves my point every show.
I didn't say anything negative about it. I just made an observation.
Very astute.
I'm sorry. So with that being said, I'm going with the squid.
There you go. I don't feel bad not picking the squid because 20,000 Leagues won the ride vehicle tournament last year, so 20K got its love. The end of Flight of Passage, absolutely, hands down. Argument over. All right, that's the last one in the bracket. So, Pete and Eric, back up to you.
Well, Pete,
holy
smokes, that was another electrifying round.
Oh, let's talk about surprises.
Let's talk about surprises. First of all, huge upset with the American Adventure finale beating Horizons. Turns out our panel, very fond of projection shows.
Loves projection shows.
They love
loves
the projection
projections.
Shows. Unless it's Muppet Vision 3D.
Oh,
in which case they change their tech
it.
And they
forget
sail the other direction. It. Muppet Vision 3D clearly eliminated, sadly, right there.
And then also, can I
something
just say,
about it, there was a dead grandmother involved.
Yeah, something about a dead grandmother, yeah, for sure.
I mean, no, nothing gets us going like a dead grandmother.
And if we look,
way more than Bean Bunny. Right?
Oh, yeah. Forget about Bean Bunny. Nobody likes him here. Let's talk about the Yeti. Just like Tinder, we love him swiping left.
Wow.
We just, when he's not swiping, we don't like him. But when he is swiping, we love him.
Everybody likes it. Also, early on, Big Al went down to Anubis.
Wow. Who would have known a typo would have won?
Yeah. The hijacker is murdered. This is Disney.
This, again.
No, it's not the first 48, guys.
We love it. Also, it's great to see the addition of Desi Diffendahl. Just literally voting for something just to see the result from the last person on the panel. Just no opinion, just, oh, I'm just going to vote for this because you do it. That was fun. Loved that. Desi Diffendahl, a great addition here. Also, let's just say that Space won over Farming. Has no one else seen the movie Signs?
Yeah. I don't. You can't
it's
see the circles
It's the only
behind
movie
it.
I've seen.
There could be a connection there, Pete. You know, and then a big one, we had the mine going down in a close battle to the Renaissance.
Wow, that was an epic battle. We were talking amongst ourselves here in the studio a few miles up the road, and...
Yeah, wait till Chapek finds out those guys aren't actually mining.
Or nothing involving crypto. Unbelievable.
They could be mining crypto, who knows? Yeah. They will be next
year. Honestly something, and note to self too, no more Banshee back rides for Piano Rob. I'm tired. If he doesn't like anyone on his back or breathing between him, he's not allowed on my back anymore.
Look, normally if you want a banshee breathing between your legs, that's like $58 on OBT. You pay double for that kind of action.
$58?
Well, depends on where
I
you go.
I need your connection.
Yeah.
Are we still live?
And then we have our biggest blowout, by the way.
Oh, what was the biggest blowout?
The jail scene with the dog.
Wow.
Dominated the crash scene from Test Track.
Yeah, people love seeing people in jail. We love crime scene. We watch Netflix. We love crime.
Classic tale of a dog that moved to Orlando with nothing but a dream and keys to a dungeon.
In his mouth.
Yeah. Not willing to trade him
as
for a human
as,
femur.
As long as it's true crime, a dog, and we're not behind bars, we'll watch it.
That is true. I can't wait to see
fantastic battles this week.
And by the way, we found out that Allison, the smallest person here, is claustrophobic. Can you imagine riding the 20,000 Leagues Under the Sea, our size, Allison?
I go through Space Mountain and I hit my hands on the roof. Allison's still trying for it and still terrified.
We have some amazing matchups coming. First, we're going to take a commercial break, though. We've got bills to pay. What better way to pay those bills than fake commercials that get our whole show
I
demonetized?
I love it, and I see there's a slew of them coming, so I think you should stick around, and we'll be right back in just a few moments. Hit the like button. Here we go.
Good work. More power!
Creature is about to explode!
Drop the shield! Yes, we here at Walt Disney World are sad to inform you that we won't have enough money or time to finish the planned attractions for our 50th anniversary celebration starting October 1st, 2021. The unexpected impacts of the COVID-19 pandemic have left us with very little money, only enough to barely afford our full executive salaries, Disney Plus show production, and construction of our Star Wars luxury resort for the insanely rich. After all that, we may only have $23 billion to spare. But don't you worry. In classic Disney fashion, we won't bring you new rides to enjoy. We'll bring you profit centers. Immersive new resort hotel experiences. Forget Tron Light Cycle Run. Instead, enjoy a stay at Disney's Contemporary Resort, our first hotel without any stairs or elevators. Just slide up and down the abandoned tracks on your luggage. The new resort will offer picturesque views of the back of Space Mountain, a gas-powered slow-speed go-kart course, and for some reason, Storybook Circus. The rooms will be the same plain white hospital room style that you know and love from us, but at an insane price since you're in the Magic Kingdom. Want a more cultured experience? Well, join us at the Remaisons Inn at the France Pavilion at Epcot. Dine at La Creperie de Paris, our one and only dining location that was totally intended for this resort, and sleep under projection domes showing poorly dubbed scenes of Ratatouille characters. The magic begins at check-in, where after we've collected your payment, we'll literally sweep you away to your room with a giant broom. Oh, and don't worry about those real-looking rats on the ground in your room, they're just part of the theme. Over in World Discovery, you'll find elegance at the Star-Lord Palms. Start your stay at our soaring atrium showcasing the empty interior of the Universe of Energy. Treat your children to our roller coaster track water slides, or savor a bite to eat at our rooftop restaurant. At Disney's Hollywood Studios, find a more value-friendly option, the Cozy Bell Motel. Sleep in one of eight large wheels of cheese that Andy dropped from his lunchbox. There's also the Animation Courtyard by Disney, where you can find rest and relaxation in your own row of the Voyage of the Little Mermaid Theater, or have a private photo session in an empty Star Wars character meet and greet. Last but not least, the Epcot Ramada. Sorry, we don't want to take on too many new hotels. We need some other company to shoulder the burden with us. Walt Disney World's 50th anniversary. More rooms, more revenue, more executive bonuses, less for you to enjoy.
You haven't even noticed, and a pity is. It's too late to fix anything now that everything has gone wrong. Thanks to JPEG, naughty JPEG.
It's been JPEG all along. And I killed Magical Express.
Hey everybody, we're back. So let's find out the Disney Parks incorrect fact of the week. The Epcot Experience will be closed and remodeled into the Epcot Sportsbook. I feel like that's a little too possible that might happen. That was some music. Let's see what's coming up on the show the next few weeks. Obviously, we've just begun March Madness tonight. It will be continuing for the next 2 weeks. That's just, we're actually not stopping. This actually just will keep going. The show will not end. We'll just be on air for the next two consecutive weeks. No, we are back next week and the following week with the conclusion of March Madness. And then before we go on break for a little bit, we do have a show on April 7th, which will be a special show dedicated to 30 years of Euro Disney, or Disneyland Paris will celebrate their 30th anniversary. Tickets available at WDWNewsTonight.com. Please join us in person if you can. If not, join us from home. We appreciate it either way. Nick, who brings us the show every week?
That would be the vacationer, the engineers of your next magical Disney vacation. Sit back and let their team of vacation planning experts craft your family's next magical Disney trip. The best part is their services are free. Visit WDWNT.travel for details. The Vacationeer, the official travel agency of WDWNT.
Thank you, Nick. You know, the show's not long enough tonight. Do you have any psychotic comments for us?
You know what? I have a few.
All right, let's do it.
Walt Disney presents...
So, we're going to start off with a photo that was posted to the WDWNT Twitter account when we went to Peppa Pig theme park. Wait, what?
That's not what's up on the screen right now.
That's not what's up on the screen. Okay, now I'll
skip that one. There you go. Is it art?
Yes, there you go. Is it art? And then we have a reply there from at Digit Game. It's not art, it's Nick, which makes it art. Yeah. There you go. All right, so next story, Disney CEO Bob Chapek more reluctant than Iger to take political stances, Insider says. At Coffee Then Tacos wrote, he should take a stance about crowd control in the parks. Yeah, yeah.
Nick always picks the best ones.
All right, we got better ones, we got better ones.
Their full name, I believe, was Coffee Then Tacos Then Restroom, I think. Their full name.
Tom, the WDWNT Twitter account tweeted this. Don't know who needs to hear this, but Zippity Doodah didn't originate as Splash Mountain. It's from a film.
Yeah.
Okay. We got a couple of responses to that one. At Kim Curlin wrote, I used to think it was from Hannah Montana. I never watched Hannah Montana when I was little, but I assumed it was from that.
So anything with a southern accent is Hannah Montana.
I assume.
I mean, if we want to cancel Hannah Montana, I'm on board.
Yeah. At Bedzy Boo wrote, by film, I assume you're referring to the masterpiece that is Disneyland Fun Sing Along.
I mean, that is a masterpiece. I love
sure,
that.
Sure. All right. Next story, Disney Enchantment fireworks cause small fire at Under the Sea, Journey of the Little Mermaid at Magic Kingdom. At Sykes Sabrina 666 wrote, I think this is a sign that they need to shut down Enchantment and bring back Happily Ever After. Maybe.
That's a sane comment.
Sane comment, right? At NH Gator 13 wrote, I guess it's not better down where it's wetter after all.
No, it was up where it's grassy. Where the fire was. Oh, stop it. That
you
wasn't.
It,
I didn't even mean that. Sweet Jesus, Eric Morton. Oh, my God. I don't even know if they heard that at home. I hope not. Wow. All right. No, I can't believe that wasn't Pete and that was Eric. That's, you two sat together for too long.
Oh, man. Rumor, Hoop-Dee-Doo musical review to be replaced with bluegrass music. Act at Pioneer Hall. At Sir Mikes-a-Lot wrote, Hoop-dee-boo!
Oh, man.
At ubiquitous underscore miss wrote, if they don't bring back Hoop-dee-doo, it'll officially become my villain origin story. Right. But then we put an update. This rumor is not true, according to Walt Disney World's communications team member.
No.
And at David Bellamy III wrote, relax, it's coming back behind a $6,000 paywall called the Fort Wilderness Galactic Campground.
It's an RV, not a box truck this time.
All right, another story, a new multi-level Disney Vacation Club wing with modern aesthetic announced for Disney's Polynesian Village Resort.
Boy.
At Wheels 518 wrote, made the tiki gods and spirits and souls of performers passed from Spirit of Aloha haunt those rooms for all eternity. At Dark Trig wrote, the new Polly, where we look down upon the original Polly owners and make them look poor. Welcome to Disney Vegas style. At Display Name 20 wrote in, Still can't believe Disney is building a Holiday Inn.
That was the best one, the Holiday Inn.
Right, Holiday Inn, yeah. All right, last story. Tom, you posted a picture. One full canopy section nears completion. Crew prepares to pour cement at Tron Light Cycle Run at Magic Kingdom. Pete, it's not liquid magic yet. One more comment left. One more. At Mandy, yes, that one wrote, they pour cement, but we can't get concrete information on an opening date. And then replying to At Mandy, yes, that one wrote, this is the end of the line for corny puns.
End of line, it's from the movie.
End of the line from
Tron. No, end of line. No. It's a movie. No. Never mind.
Yeah.
End of line. I give up. Can we do the segment where you two act like idiots? Let's just do that.
About time.
Welcome to Liquid Magic, everyone!
Sampling a couple more libations at Raglan Road. Very well done.
It's like a pound of bacon in here.
That is a lot of bacon.
Look at that. There's so much bacon.
Wow. All right, so you went with the Arthur's Old Fashioned, which is the Tullamore Dew 12, Guinness Simple Syrup, Guinness Cured Bacon, and Anastoric Orange Bitter. Oh, yeah. We're excited about that.
All right.
Let's try that one first, and then we'll get into mine.
I'm gonna get those out of the way. That's like
it's Guinness marinated bacon.
It is.
All right, here we go. And a Guinness simple syrup.
Oh, that's good.
Oh, he's an old-fashioned aficionado.
That is heaven. I love that.
Wow, that's surprisingly very smooth.
There is so much going on there.
That is, you get all the notes from a Guinness. Wow. Well, we know that might be one of the ones we're making.
Oh, no doubt. Oh,
wow. All right, then I got what we're calling the Dublin Donkey. This has the Teeling Small Batch Irish Whiskey, ginger beer, fresh lemon sour, candy ginger, and lime.
Ooh.
Here we go. That's good. See, that's me. That and the rosemary whiskey sour. That's yummy.
Oh, wow.
That's good. Yeah. The crowd likes it.
Give it up for these drinks.
It's going to be a tough decision.
These are contenders.
These are definitely contenders.
Oh, my goodness. That's a great one. All right, Pete, I got us a flight here.
I like it. Looks good.
All right, we got to decide, though, what we're making for Liquid Magic.
All right, yeah, we've had a lot of great cocktails.
We have, I don't know. I think I need some more whiskey in me before I decide.
You know what, I always find it best to, mull these important decisions over. We don't just go into the drinks we make all willy-nilly.
No.
You gotta sip,
so let's
sip, and think.
I can't decide yet. So
why don't we just open our minds a little bit?
Yeah, open our minds, open our hearts, open our kidneys, let's do it.
Should we go in opposite order? I'll start on this side.
All right.
Cilantro.
Oh, yeah. Filming this, I don't know.
I don't know
if you want to see this.
This could get ugly. They might want to see it.
I like that.
Yeah, mine was clean too.
Clean, yeah.
like that one too.
You gotta cleanse the palate now. Yeah. Alright, this one's a smoky sarcasm.
This is the one we both waited for.
This smells like a forest fire.
Oh, so much heat in there. Oh my god. I'm gonna be in heaven here. Oh boy. Alright, I'm ready. Wow, that is heaven.
The nose on this is fire emoji, fire emoji.
Oh, man. What do you think? Yeah?
I feel like I'm growing into a real boy.
You are. There's the hair. I can see it. I can see it.
I'm going to have to shave this bad boy. Yeah. That is delicious. All right. I feel like I'm honing in on... I think that's for us.
I can do a dance now. Let's go.
Next time we're on stage.
Let's go dance. All right.
We don't want to upstage them, but maybe we'll do a little something.
On the show?
On the show. I think we might have to do a little something on the show. A little something.
Sorry, a little something. A little something.
Well, sir, I'll let you have the... Here, you can have your pick.
All right.
I guess we'll see everybody on Liquid Magic live.
It's a surprise.
I guess we'll see you in the studio.
Yeah! Look at that! Pete representing.
It is time!
I can't believe
it. It's St. Patrick's Day, and here we are at Liquid Magic. I am so excited.
This is insane.
By the way, hi, I'm Pete Carney, and this is LoCicero.
Look at this.
We have our own backdrop. We have our own little we have our own space.
But guess what, Pete? For our first Liquid Magic, you could derobe. Yeah, you could derobe. Yeah, take off whatever you want.
Hit the floor.
For our first Liquid Magic that falls on St. Patrick's Day, we are debuting the Liquid Magic Shaker.
Look.
With a top.
This.
With a top.
It has a top. So there's.
This is insane.
You would think there'd be less spillage. But we're going to make four drinks for you tonight. And who knows what's going to happen.
All right.
I say we start with one of the drinks I had earlier today.
Yeah.
And that we had while we were there.
Let's do
it. One of our favorites. This is the rosemary and maple whiskey sour. So here's what you want to do. Mm-hmm. First, you're going to start some Irish whiskey. Any Irish whiskey.
Which one
what
you
do
you use?
What do you want to do?
You got the Jamo. Regular Jameson. You got the stout edition Jameson.
Choice. You pick.
Well, I think for this one you want to go Jamo.
So what you want to do is you want to put about 3 ounces in there. And the way you count 3 ounces is that you talk to a studio audience for a little bit while pouring.
It's liquid magic.
Thank you. There it is. Then what you want to do is, in this drink, the rosemary really makes it. So I would recommend going to your local store and find some real fresh rosemary. I'm going to crush it and press it a little bit. It's not mint, so you don't have to spank it.
No.
But you want to get it in there.
Whoever make sure spanked rosemary.
No one spanks rosemary. That is, if we've learned anything.
No.
That's what we know.
She
but
does
you know, you
not
crush
like
it up
that.
And just get it in there. Then you're going to need some maple syrup. Nick, you got some maple syrup for me?
Dude, I got maple syrup.
Of
look
you
at
do.
That
look
right
at
there.
This.
Some in there.
Here we go, a little maple syrup. Look at that.
It's liquid magic.
Yeah.
We are on point tonight. Here we go. After that, what we're gonna need is, I know this sounds unusual. However, if you go to a lot of, let's say speakeasies or upscale.
Uptown.
Uptown.
Yeah.
But, you know, let's say like
uppity.
Fancy schmancy,
oh,
right?
Those
need a password to get in.
Yeah.
Is they might use egg whites.
They might.
In a drink, so
that's why we got them.
We happen to have some egg whites right here, and you know you get the
you
yellows
splash
out
a little bit in, yeah.
And you just do a little bit. We're gonna just do a little tiny bit. We're just gonna just a little bit of egg white.
It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic.
Look at that
it's
egg white
liquid magic.
In there. No yellow.
It's
no yellow.
You
probably did like some
it's
squats.
Liquid magic.
It.
Yep.
Yeah. So you need a little bit. I know that seemed like a lot, but not a lot.
Protein.
You know. Yeah. And we're all about protein here on the show. Obviously, we both work out. I mean, come on. Obviously, we hold up this show.
Yeah.
So then what we're gonna do is a little bit of lemon sour.
Lemon sour, homemade
so Nick was
lemon sour.
Awesome enough to make his own lemon sour.
So equal parts lemon juice, water, and what else? I have sugar. Yeah, there you
Look
go.
At that.
Reduce
and
it on
here
the stovetop.
Just to pour it into a drink.
Put it in. Put it in.
Nick's the man. He makes
it's liquid magic.
Sour. Yeah, you need a sour.
Yeah, we need a little bit of that.
It's a whiskey sour.
You want a little bit of sour. You want it in there. And then what I like to do is also we're going to add a little bit more rosemary. And again, you want to crush it up. Rosemary really brings it all together. So this drink's about the rosemary and the lemon. It's going to smell wonderful. And the way we garnish it is really going to be what it all comes down to.
What's some ice?
We need some ice, but first we're going to muddle it a little bit. I want to mix up that rosemary. We're going to mix up the egg whites. We're going to get the lemon in there.
Agitating it.
We're going to agitate it. This is like a farm in a cup. I mean, you got rosemary, egg whites.
Maple syrup.
Maple syrup, lemon. Here we go. Let's have some fun.
Farm in the cup.
Here we go. Let's get some ice in there. Here we go. By the way, have I said you're doing a great job tonight?
No, you haven't.
All right, here we go. The brand new liquid magic shaker. Are you ready? Here we go.
Shake, 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 Sinora. Shake your body liner. Shake, 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 Sinora. Shake it all the time. Work, 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 Sinora.
All right, any some more ice?
Oh, yeah, I can do that.
Polish me off. We don't have lemon to garnish this drink, but I would normally do a lemon wedge with a little spruce of garlic. But instead, we'll do this. I'll make it look pretty like this. Here we go. Just for your friends at home.
Oh, no, we do the, hold on. Give me one of those sprigs. Give me that sprig. Right. This is what they did at the restaurant, right?
Well, that's an orange on a lemon.
No, that's what they did, though. They put it
they
through.
They put it through the middle. Yeah, but it's a whole different
All
taste
right,
profile.
Whatever. Just
but if you have a lemon, imagine that. Imagine that. Here we go. Let's try it out. Here
it's
we go.
Liquid magic.
Oh, it's better than the pregame one.
It's liquid magic.
I think we did a great job here. Here we go. All right. First or second? What do you want?
Second.
All right, here we go. I love this. And I had this. Here we go.
You got a little sprig.
That is so good. Honestly, I think we friggin' nailed it.
Wow.
If anything, maybe too much Irish whiskey, but that is delicious. Whoa. Put it on the spinner. Look at that thing. There go, ladies and gentlemen. The rosemary maple whiskey sour.
Can we stop here?
We probably should put more on top.
That is amazing.
That was so good.
All right,
let's do a few more, and then Tom's going to want to drink all of that. Here we go.
All right, PJ's Poison.
PJ's Poison. All right, so this is another one we have, again, not named after me. My middle name is James, Peter James.
Yeah.
Yep.
So
what do we got?
This one, we're going to muddle an orange in there. Can I have your muddler? So we're going to do a little bit of that, right?
Absolutely.
All right. Then we're going to toss some bitters in here. Okay. We got some bitters. All right. A few dashes.
Is that a few dashes?
That's a few dashes.
Okay.
Yeah. Splash of lemon juice. So we're going to take this and just throw a splash of this in there. All right, then.
This is cleaned out and ready to go for you, my friend.
How about this? So this is whiskey-infused orange marmalade.
Stop.
Yes. Oh, I'm not stopping it.
No, because, all right, so when we went and tested these ingredients.
Yeah.
Real quick, we got a super chat in honor of Josh, $25, that said raise a toast to Josh.
Well, in that case, let's finish Josh. The drink.
Yeah, everyone should have
Is that good or what, though? What do you think about that?
That's not good. I don't know.
Get the
Oh!
You know what Josh would have said? Josh would have said more whiskey. Josh would have said that's 10 out of 10. Just because you said it wasn't good.
Whiskey infused orange marmalade, right there.
Well, my friend here makes this delicious drink. Nick has put in a full effort. These are outstanding. You've gone above and beyond this week.
Then we add some
It's liquid magic.
I measure my 3 ounces.
It's liquid magic.
Sorry, Pete.
It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic.
That's not 3 ounces.
It's about.
You're measuring wrong. What are we doing here?
All right, we're gonna throw some ice in there.
Yeah, that'll do.
I measured. Do you think I put in too little or too? No, no.
We'll find out.
No, tell me.
I'll tell you when I taste it.
No, tell me.
I'll tell you
more?
When I taste it.
Do I want more?
I think always
it's side. Liquid magic.
More is always better. All right. Oh, there you go. All right, let's not get crazy. That's Hendrix. That's expensive.
I mean,
yeah.
All right. All right, here we go. We're gonna shake this.
Shake, Sinora, shake your body line. By the way,
we're wearing matching outfits. Shake, Sinora, shake it all the time. Work, Sinora, work it all the time.
Strain this over ice. Gonna throw some ice in here. All right.
It's liquid magic.
Oh, that looks actually, that looks
right?
Good.
The color, right?
Oh, we got it.
It's liquid magic.
This is why you always add a little bit more, by the way. You see that?
Yeah, I get it.
It's liquid magic.
You can't do it exactly.
Oh, we'll put it there. Don't worry.
Oh, we'll get it on the spinner.
First?
Oh, before we drink it. Well, what fun is that? You want our reaction?
All right, look at the drink. Look at the drink.
First of all, we didn't even garnish it.
Look at the drink.
It's liquid magic.
What did we even garnish it with? There we go. You good? Spin.
Okay, there you go.
All right, you got it? All right, you see enough of this drink? Let's
try
it.
Come on. Try it first. Come on.
It's liquid magic.
What do we think? So this is the PJ's poison.
Oh, that's better than what we had at Raglan Road.
Shut the front door.
No, come on, taste it.
It's liquid magic.
I don't think we really loved it, but that is really good.
The nose on this is 10 out of 10.
I know. It's the Hendrix. It's really good, right? Like, that is much better than we had at Raglan Road. Sorry, Raglan Road.
That's unbelievable.
Not sorry. Right?
That's unbelievable.
You did such a good job. I'm so proud of you. That's
unbelievable.
I know.
There you go. One. PJ's poison.
Wow.
You're going to want to, I mean, for the first time in history, literally do everything we just did on these two beverages.
It's the orange marmalade. Do your own. All right, so I bought canned orange marmalade. Whatever.
What?
But I know. Shh.
Okay.
But I infused it with a lot of Irish whiskey. So it's
that's the secret. Yeah. So if you want to know how you make the mixers, sign up for Nick's OnlyFans. He does all these mixers at his own home. He shows you how he makes the mixers.
While wearing a kilt.
While wearing a kilt and just a kilt alone. Are we ready for two more?
Oh, let's do it.
Let's do two more. It is St. Patrick's Day. Do you guys want two more cocktails? That was the weakest.
Hey, what the hell?
To be
I'm
honest,
done.
I want two more cocktails.
All right.
Bring us back to March Madness where we talk about. Anyway.
How about the Moscow Mule?
I'd rather a Dublin Donkey.
Dublin Donkey!
We're gonna
I love it!
Dublin Donkey. This is pretty exciting stuff. So, what we're gonna do here is, again, a little bit of Irish whiskey. So, let's grab a cup here. And let's grab Jamo, or should we do Tully?
Yeah,
Tully.
Tully.
Little Tullamore do. And again, 3 ounces
here. It's liquid magic.
Boom, 3 ounces. You want to measure that? Where's your measuring device? You want to see if it's close? Wait, is this three?
Yeah.
So is it, is it an ounce and a half?
Yeah, you got it.
All right, let's see if I'm accurate. All right, where's a cup? Give me a cup. Oh. Give me that one.
No, you can't use that one.
I just want to see if I'm accurate.
You can't use that one.
I just want to show
I'm not giving you that one.
Let's just show the people at home. Here. Let's do it. There's an ounce and a half. And then I did spill some before, but. Look at that. I'm a little short because I spilled a little bit. So I'm actually short.
Yeah.
I am shorting the
alcohol. How dare you?
You see what happens?
Do
this
it.
Is why I showed it my way. So anyway, what do you need here is 3 ounces of Irish.
It's liquid magic.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah.
Here we go. Let's do this. So you need 3 ounces of Irish whiskey. However, I recommend 3.5 ounces. Then you need a little bit of lemon sour syrup. What is lemon sour syrup, Nick?
Equal parts lemon juice, equal parts sugar and water. Reduce it on the stovetop for a little while until you dissolve all the sugar.
You guys think these drinks just come easy?
Easy.
Get out of here.
Nothing's easy.
Here
wait
we
till
go.
You see
we're
the.
We're gonna do a little bit.
It's
so what we
liquid
need here
magic.
Is we want approximately 1/2 ounce. So that's gonna be about 3 little tablespoons.
Right. Wait till you see
and then
this.
From here, what you want is a little bit of candy ginger. Candy now I said, Nick, ginger. We can't do candy ginger. We can't do it. And Nick said,
I said, let me buy some ginger. Let me boil it in some water. Let me then put it through a strainer. Let me then dump it back in a pot with some water and sugar. And let me candy this sucker. And that's
and
what
then
I did.
I got out of the pool and ginger. Was like, that seems
just
like
try
a
one,
lot of work.
Try one. Try one.
It's liquid magic.
That's so good. Oh my God. This is like sushi dessert. I need rice. And it's super sour.
We're gonna throw a couple of those.
Well, this is gonna change everything for the rest of the night. But here we go. That's in there. And then what we're gonna do is we're gonna chop a little ginger beer. Top it off with a little bit of ginger beer. Here we go.
Yeah. You gonna do that now?
Yeah, why not?
Okay, I thought you were going to stir it up first.
No. I want a little bit of ginger beer in there first. We'll do the lime at the end. So let's put it in our liquid magic mixer. Here we go.
It's liquid magic.
I'm going to chill it, so if we have some ice, that would be
great. Yeah, you got some ice.
Yeah, of course.
I'll get your lime.
Antarctica? All right, here we go. Get this on here. Let's get this on top. I also love that this is now the liquid magic mixer right there.
I know.
Shake, 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 Sinora. Shake your body liner. Shake, shake,
worry,
shake, Sinora. Shake it all the time.
All right, let's ice me. This ginger is
wow.
Extremely sour and sweet. It's very good, though.
Lime?
Yes, we're going to shoot with some lime. All right, here we go. Should be just right, perfect. We'll do a little squeeze of lime, beautiful. We'll garnish it right there. Gonna put it in the spinner.
We're gonna have to spin it first. They always
again. So this is the Dublin Donkey. What do you have here? So Irish whiskey, lemon sour syrup, ginger, well candy ginger, candy. Ginger beer, and a squeeze of lime. Oh no. Oh no.
Foos or booze?
Swish.
It's liquid magic.
It's a barbaric midnight neck.
It's lemon ash, a little bit of whiskey schnitz, tasty treat. See?
It's liquid magic. It's liquid magic.
Oi, it's packing.
Yeah, I like it too. Yum yum tum tum. More for me. Thank you very much.
It's liquid magic.
Well, it was good to see you. Thanks, Merida.
Okay.
Oh, another
Move
person
down.
Who speaks nonsense.
Was that the third drink? We have a third drink?
Yeah, we still have more. Okay. I mean,
we're out of time.
Well, no, because he has to do his old-fashioned. Nick
also, his mic, like, fell off at some point, so.
Well, we have to do Nick's old-fashioned. However,
oh, is it there?
That, Meredith really seemed to like it. I haven't tried it yet. But
how quickly can you do this drink?
Well, this is the best drink.
All
this
right,
is Nick's
go
drink.
Quickly.
Out of time? Has no one ever seen this show?
Out of time.
Has no one ever watched this show before? If you're a new viewer, thanks so much for watching. Hi, I'm Pete Carney.
By the way.
We have never finished on time in 15 years.
By the way.
Awesome.
Not bad. All right.
That is delicious.
This one's pretty easy.
You know what I feel like we're missing is a little bit of background music. We'll do that for the future.
Okay.
You know, Bob's like,
shake, 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 Sinora.
Like lower,
shake
but like really low, like 5%. Yeah.
It's liquid magic.
This is an
well, that
Irish,
of course is important.
An Irish old fashioned.
All right, can I just say the reason we say this for last, and I don't want to cut you off, is that Nick loves old fashions. Am I right? And he is the ultimate judge. So we saved the best drink for last because you loved this old fashioned.
Yeah, it was so good.
So here we go. This is the most important drink of the night. And no matter what happens, if you've learned anything tonight, it's that liquid magic matters more than what anything Tom says.
All right. This is heaven. This is a Guinness simple.
I can just shut you off, right?
Yes.
Hey, Nick is making a drink.
Guinness simple syrup.
How do you make that?
Bottle of Guinness, some sugar, you reduce it on the stovetop till all the sugar is dissolved, and you're left with this beautiful
It's liquid
syrup.
Magic.
Unbelievable.
Look at that.
Oh my God, we can look at that all day. Maybe take more time looking at it.
Should I put it on the spinner? There you go. All right. We're going to throw some orange bitters in here.
Speaking of bitters, thanks so much again, Tom, for having me on the show.
Wow. All right. So I'm going to go with the Jameson Stout Edition Irish Whiskey.
We're mixing it up a bit.
You want to do the 3 ounces? I'm not.
Here's how you do it. You just talk when you pour it. I'll tell you when it's 3 ounces. Right. Look at me. Look at, never break eye contact.
Hey, Pete.
It's liquid magic. I'm making it in the cup. No. You have to pour it into the actual cup. All right. You're wasting so much Jameson.
Wait. I can do this.
All right. Start pouring and look at me.
Hey, Pete, how are you doing?
Great, now it's enough. Liquid magic. Perfect.
All right.
That's going to be a very delicious drink.
Awesome. I'm going to stir this up.
Yeah, just stir it. Yeah, that's really going to make the difference. Besides someone ringing the doorbell, what else is in this drink?
Oh, that's it. It's super simple.
No way, it's that easy?
It's that easy.
All right, we need some ice or something.
A little bit of ice.
I'm so afraid because this was so delicious at the bar. Are you ready? Maybe mix it with the ice. Okay, never mind.
Okay, I can do it.
You know what I'm being told? Tom says, wrap keep vamping, we have a lot of time.
Okay. All right, here we go.
It's liquid magic.
Oh, you don't have to chug the whole thing. We can share it. Mm. Mm. Is it that good? Stop the madness.
No, it is. It is.
It's liquid magic.
It is.
Very good. I'll give you a hug. Happy St. Patrick's Day.
Oh, God.
What a great liquid magic. Honestly, four of the best cocktails we've ever made. Come on, put them out here.
Oh, yeah.
There they are.
Wow.
Happy St. Patrick's Day from Liquid Magic. What Love a great
it.
Addition.
Love it.
Actually, make all of these at home. Please go home and do it. It's unbelievable.
Here's the recipe. Take them.
Yeah, here, take them. Take up the recipes. I mean, we love to talk a little bit longer, but I mean, sadly, that's the end of the show. Thank you so much for watching. There's more show. All right, so let's kick it to commercial. We'll be right back with more March Madness right after this. Stay tuned. Let's go.
Yeah.
WDWNT presents Timekeeping, a year-by-year journey through the history of the vacation kingdom of the world. Join us for the premiere Tuesdays at 10 p.m. Eastern or watch on demand anytime on the WDW News Today YouTube channel.
Find myself at Flower and Garden, looking for some food to eat. Gotta get a spork with Spike the Bee. 58 pallets of unsold units standing right in front of me. Here for his fifth straight festival, Spike the Bee. Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee, Spike the Bee. Perfect for any food type, Spike the bee. And while it's good for soup and chili, he's also perfect for poutine and Tupelo honey spoon bread. Spike the bee. Plastic forks and spoons are wasteful, and they can't ever hope to be that versatile festival flatware. Spike the bee. Spike the bee. Spike the bee. Spike the bee. Yeah, spike the bee. For blood orange margaritas.
Margaritas.
Spike the bee.
How do you eat that with a spork?
Spike the bee. Spike the bee. Spike the bee. Yeah, spike the bee. Disney hopes you'll finally purchase spike the bee.
Welcome to Hour 7 of News Tonight. Thanks for being here. Real quick plug, we'll talk about it more next week, but we do have a new shirt out from Carousel Products. I'm very proud of it. It's the Bread Service is Love, Bread Service is Life shirt. It's gorgeous. It has the Sanaa plates. It's great. Go check it out, carouselproducts.com. Let's find out what's debuting this week on Broadway. Maybe Poppins? Maybe, I don't know. It's on hold. All right, back to the madness.
And we are back in the studio. Pete, more incredible action lies ahead. There are some big seeds coming up, including Flight into Imagination, the Wizard of Oz scene, all kinds of favorites. They've got to be nervous back there. Look,
I haven't had this much action in 1998. This is very exciting. Out of the gate, we have some, I mean, what we think should be easy matchups. But with this panel, I don't know.
They've got to dig deep. Look, if you had one shot.
One opportunity.
Or one opportunity.
Mom's spaghetti.
To seize everything you've ever wanted in one moment.
Then this...
Would you capture it or just let it slip?
Exactly what I was
thinking.
They're
puking up Tony's spaghetti all over their sweaters right now. We're going to go under the rotunda, back to the panelists.
I cannot wait. I'm at the end of my
seat. For this next round.
Let's get back to it.
Hello from the window. Yeah. Oh, boy. All right, let's get started. What's the first matchup? We have the Flight into Imagination from the original Journey into Imagination versus the Rainforest from It's a Small World. Lauren, why don't you start us off?
I'm going to say Rainforest just to be against Journey into Imagination.
Wow. You, whoa, man.
You're awesome, Lauren.
Colleen. Colleen.
I don't know.
What? I think that's the only Small World scene we picked, isn't it?
It well, because be. I don't really remember Journey into Imagination.
I never watched the videos.
So I'm sort of... ask someone else. I do. I need to watch the video to remember.
So, Nick, you already picked? Yeah. Colleen, did you pick anything yet?
No, I need to watch the video.
We don't have time.
I don't have time.
Go to everyone
else. Fast forward, Jake.
Come
prepare
back
to fast
me.
Forward.
She doesn't
Allison, go ahead.
Imagination... Hands
two to
down.
One for Imagination. Desi.
I'm still bitter that the rainforest beat out the Polynesian scene, so Imagination.
You go, Rob?
What? This scene with Dreamfinder is fantastic. It's a classic Epcot scene. I'm going with that.
Yeah, I agree. Same for me. Colleen, it doesn't matter. What do you want?
I'll get imagination.
Imagination. Good. Imagination wins. Next matchup. We didn't even get to finish the film. Doesn't matter. Let's keep going. That was an easy one. All right. They're going to get harder. The fifth dimension from the Twilight Zone Tower of Terror versus the Magic Mirror, which we have here as a television tonight.
Oh, thank you for referencing
from Enchanted Tales with Belle. Lauren, I saw you make a face that this was a hard choice, so you get to go first.
The Magic Mirror is so cool. I have to go fifth dimension scene. I have a tattoo of it on my body forever.
How many of the things in the tournament do you have a tattoo of is the question that has to be asked now.
That's a fair question. I have to go fifth dimension. It pains me. Everyone give... Look at my beautiful...
Lauren spent so many hours making this Magic Mirror television today.
Thank you. Yay. Thank you.
Colleen.
This is a hard one. I didn't want to ride Tower of Terror as a kid because of the scene, not like the ride. I thought the scene was scary.
Oh, really?
Yeah. Okay. The ride was fine.
There's just a translucent child. I mean, what's so scary about it?
Yeah, I always thought, I thought the Twilight Zone part was scary, but this is such a great effect. Yeah. With the mirror, and people are so surprised by it. I love watching how other people respond to effects. So, I don't know. That's hard.
Do you need to watch the video?
I'll say Twilight Zone. Tower of Terror.
Nick.
Yeah. I have a tattoo of the Magic Mirror. You guys want to see? Magic Mirror. Yeah.
It's so cool.
Yeah, really?
Oh, yeah.
Well,
yeah,
I mean, these are both great, right? That needs to be said. These are both stupendous scenes. This is a wow moment, this thing.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. But fifth dimension, I think the greater wow was... that elevator goes forward. Like, no one, we were amazed that the thing had seats, never mind the fact that, like, we were still getting over the fact that, oh, there's seats. And then as soon as we figure that out, the thing's pulling forward. We're like, what's happening? So, Tower. Rob?
I'm with you. The elevator leaving the elevator shaft to go forward, the suspense at that point is insane. Tower Terror.
Desi.
I am shocked. I do not think that the Magic Mirror deserves to be this low of a seed. It is such a wow moment, and it's shocking for everybody who sees it.
I think a lot of people haven't seen it is the problem, right? Because it's in a meet and greet, essentially.
Yeah.
So I think that's kind of why it ended up where it did.
I know that the fifth dimension already won, so I'm just going to give my vote to the Magic Mirror because it deserves more votes.
That's fair. Allison?
Even though Magic Mirror has such a great wow factor, the fifth dimension really gives you a little bit more of that suspense and anticipation, and it scares you, so fifth dimension.
Yeah, and if Enchanted Tales does come back and you haven't seen that, go in there. Yeah. Please,
the
do yourself a favor. Lumiere's great, too. It's a great, Enchanted Tales is a great attraction. It's very underrated. Really. Even if you don't have kids, you should go see it. Sit in the back, though, don't sit in the front.
I go without kids all the time.
I knew it was coming, and I still couldn't
stop
it.
If you're a tall guy, you'll get to be in the show.
I've never sat in the seats. I've been the stupid guard every time. I've never actually seen it from the seats.
Oh, I made Lucas be one of the knights once. He was not happy about that.
You made him participate in something.
He
didn't talk to you for like weeks. Or
he was not happy. He was visibly very upset about that.
He had to whittle his own cutout.
What's worse is my mother can do high notes, and so she sings like the wardrobe and the audience parts for her, and it's very dramatic. She thinks very highly of herself.
That's what I'm going to make Lucas do next, is sing in front of people.
Is everyone good?
We're good.
Yeah, we're good.
Thanks. I'll continue. What's next? The cave scene from Avatar Flight of Passage versus the big blue world from The Seas with Nemo and Friends. Allison, why don't you start us off?
I am going to go with the cave from Flight of Passage. I think it's a lovely scene. It's very calming, and you really get to pause and take everything in for this scene. So
a lot
that's
of banshee crotch breathing.
There is
too much.
Too much.
There's too much. Well, I think I know where Rob's going to go with this one.
Desi.
Who seeded these? Because the Magic Mirror is definitely better than the Big Blue World cave scene.
True.
Rob.
I'm not the biggest fan of Flight of Passage, and I know that people are going to disagree with me. You get projections of our favorite fish characters swimming with real fish. It's a cool effect. You get the song that gets stuck in your head for the next 17 days. I'm going to go with Big Blue World.
I'm with Rob. I the first time I saw this, I thought it was the coolest thing. The rest of the ride's a waste of time. But this is spectacular, this moment. The song is very Epcot. It's a nice ending to this ride. It's the scene that validates the whole thing existing, I think. Nick.
I agree with Tom, but the cave scene at Flight of Passage is my pick to go the entire way. Like, I think that is just the most, the fact that Disney has the balls to, like, say, all right.
Why is there so much crotch discussion in the Flight of Passage tonight? I don't understand.
We are going to give you this, like, crazy rush of a simulator, and then we're just going to stop everything. We're just going to sit here. We're just going to sit here and chill. That takes guts. That is trusting in your audience. That's trusting in your guest. That is an emotional scene that is just unlike anything else at Walt Disney World. So for that reason, cave scene.
Colleen?
I think the cave scene is very important in Avatar Flight of Passage because that is the scene in which I'm able to breathe and then calm down enough that I'm not going to vomit. And that's really important for people who have motion sickness. But I agree, a Big Blue World, that's such a neat effect. And, you know, I think kids get a kick out of that. You see these cartoon fish, but they're with the real fish. And I think that that's great, so I picked that.
Wow. Ooh. Lauren.
Oh, wow. Oh, this isn't
you're
even
the
hard.
Decision.
I'm going with Big Blue World.
Yeah! Oh, my God!
I already fought for
the cosmic rays of 2022,
oh,
man.
No. This is like the only place you can hear this song now.
Oh,
no,
hey, it's true. Three of us agree with you.
Yeah, this is like the only place you can hear this song now, and it's so good. So.
Oh, that show didn't come back. I'm shocked.
I know, crazy. It's so cute, crazy. And I like Nemo, so.
Oh, Nemo.
I already fought for a Flight of Passage. It's got something else.
Wait, this
We're
is
good.
Better than the finale.
We've got the other scene in
this
here. Well, majority rules, as Horizons once said.
So,
wow.
There you go. Next matchup.
What's Horizons?
What'd you say?
What's Horizons?
What's Horizons? I'll tell you when you're older. All right, the stretching room from the Haunted Mansion against Donald Crashes More Butt Stuff and Mickey's Philhar Magic. Lauren, why don't you start us off?
Donald's
butt.
Wow.
Stretching room makes me so angry because everyone quotes it. It ruins the scene. It literally ruins the scene. Like,
So we're detracting so the annoying. Scene just because annual pass holders are in it.
I can't stand CPs. I will go on record saying that. And they ruin the stretching room for me. Also, I love Philhar Magic, and I love that ending. When I worked at Magic Kingdom and our training room was right underneath Philhar Magic, and every 15 minutes you'd hear Donald crash through the wall. It just made me laugh every time, so Donald.
Colleen.
These are both really great scenes, but I am gonna go with the stretching room from Haunted Mansion, and honestly I'm shocked that there's still a dude who committed suicide hanging above you. That's amazing. That sounds wrong now that I said it out loud, but it's surprising
it
in a way that has lasted.
Yeah, but not as easy to remove as some of the other scenes.
Wait, but Donald's right here.
Yeah,
there's
right
Donald
there.
Is right
there's
there.
The butt.
It's a great. I love Philhar Magic. That's great.
Nick,
Donald.
Yeah.
Wow.
Not even ridiculous that he's even in the same conversation here.
What?
What?
What? There's like 12 Haunted Mansion scenes.
There's so much Haunted Mansion.
It's because it's very good.
It's very good.
Give something else.
That Donald scene surprises everyone. It's so cool.
Yeah. Rob?
I do appreciate the Donald scene because you'll see all the kids turn around and none of the parents do because they feel like it could be real.
Right?
Yeah. But that Haunted Mansion scene, I have done the jigsaw puzzles for all four of those stretching paintings we've done in my house. They're all framed. I'm going with the stretching room. That's the iconic
one. It's one of my favorite justifications in March Madness history.
Yes.
I've done the jigsaw puzzles. Desi.
We don't even have the best version of the stretching room. Like,
what are you talking about?
We don't actually move in our stretching room.
It was because they didn't have to.
You also can't.
The look on people's faces, I feel like everybody just knows the Haunted Mansion, so you're expecting the stretching room. When you see people who have never done PhilharMagic before, and even people who have, who didn't realize that Donald actually crashes in the back, and you see their faces, like, because I always pointed out to my kids, look, there's Donald. And you see, and people around me who hear it just turn around like, whoa, oh my gosh, I can't believe he's actually there. And then you see him, like, actually fall down, and it's not just, like, you know, a duck butt sitting there. It does something.
Yeah, I hate those attractions where there's just an ass in the wall and it doesn't do anything. I hate them. It's the worst. There's too many of those. Yeah.
Gotta go with duck butt.
Yeah. I can't believe this is happening. Allison.
I also cannot believe this is happening. There's no way. It has to be the stretching room. What are we talking about here? Why is there a comparison between the two?
There's people, people really don't want this duck butt to be eliminated. You know, very quickly. Allison, do you want to say something?
Why, what?
Do you want to elaborate or no?
Okay.
No, I'm just trying to move us along.
No, I've said what I wanted to say.
They're both great, right? The duck butt's fantastic, but it's the stretching room. I mean, for me, I know people talk about the ballroom. The stretching room is the scene. That's the scene.
Can we get a jigsaw puzzle of Donald's butt?
But the stretching room is the perfect combination of the things that make the mansion, right? Funny and scary, right? The portraits as they reveal. I don't know. It's a stretching room. Sorry, Donald. It's all right. His butt will be there for 3 weeks. It's fine. People will remember. What's the next one? The pre-show from Muppet Vision 3D against the lift hill from Maelstrom.
What?
Is that right? No, that's what I thought was going to come up. Okay. Let's redo that. The Art Deco future from Horizons, which Lauren has never seen, against the pre-show from Rock and Roller Coaster. Lauren, start us off.
Yeah, Rock and Roller Coaster.
Rock and Roller Coaster. There you go. Colleen.
Horizons.
Nick.
Horizons.
Allison.
Horizons.
Desi.
Wait a minute.
Isn't that Space Mountain?
You didn't even do it.
Because I was worried about...
We're not even on
We
camera.
Can't even see it.
Horizons.
Rob?
Yeah, it's hard for me to vote against Aerosmith because it's Aerosmith and I'm a musician, but this scene is amazing in Horizons. Horizons.
Yeah, I mean, I love this pre-show, but that robot butler is the most indelible part of Horizons, probably. It's Horizons. And Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow played in that scene, too, which is great. So no offense to Aerosmith, but they can't compete with Great Big Beautiful Tomorrow. What's the next matchup? All right, here we go. Right. The pre-show of Muppet Vision against the lift hill of Maelstrom. Lauren, go ahead.
Muppet Vision. This is the last Muppet, I need to emphasize this. This is the last Muppet Vision scene in this list. I will, please.
So
Maelstrom isn't even there anymore. It got replaced by Frozen. It can't be that great.
Whoa.
Like, come on.
Wow.
Muppet Vision.
Yeah, I was going to say,
ride was crap.
We're going to have to escort Lauren to her car after the show tonight based on all of these choices.
That's okay.
Colleen.
I'm going to go with Muppet Vision because it's so fun and the Muppets are great and they should be appreciated more.
Yeah. Nick?
So true.
Well, yeah, I mean, if we're hitting these two specific scenes up against each other, the Muppets wins, hands down. You know, there's other scenes in Maelstrom that I might vote ahead of this scene, but if this is what we're voting on, Muppets pre-show. Because it's epic.
This is difficult. I mean, the Maelstrom lift hill isn't much of anything, but it is probably one of the best lines of dialogue in any attraction ever, right? It's really what it's about. It does that face in the wall and the dialogue really are something special. But the Muppet Vision pre-show might be the greatest Muppet thing made, period, right?
Right?
So
like, it's
crazy. How do you argue against that? So Muppets, Allison?
2 points. One is that if I go into that attraction and I've missed half of that pre-show, I won't go into the theater. I'll stay behind so that I can watch the entire pre-show. And then a second one is a big shout out to when we did the WDWNT Live, that girl that recreated the entire Muppet pre-show. Right. Remember her? Shout out to you if you're watching.
I feel the same with the post-show, the Maelstrom. If I miss part of that, I stay late till the film restarts.
I just really want to see that kid touch that boat.
Oh, yeah.
Yes.
He touched the boat.
Like the easiest matchup we've had thus far, Muppets.
Oh, thank God.
Rob.
It's definitely Muppets, and with Muppets too, you also get the room that the pre-show's in. With you get the Jim Henson Muppet, you get the Annette Funicello reference.
It's so detailed.
Yeah. It's definitely the Muppets pre-show.
Yeah, we'll talk more about it in future weeks. All right, next matchup. Let's keep the ball rolling. The Running Carnotaurus from Dinosaur versus the Riverboat Finale from Splash Mountain. Rob, would you like to start us off?
Splash Mountain is my favorite ride, but there's better parts to Splash Mountain, which is why I am going to go with that dinosaur chasing you. That's another scary moment. I still have trouble watching him all the way because I still think he's going to get me to this day. Dinosaur running.
Desi?
That ferry boat is incredible, and you know it's like the one thing that's going to stay when they redo this ride. So, ferry boat.
Allison?
I mean, I disagree with Rob. I think that is probably the best scene in Splash Mountain. So I'm going with the ferry boat.
This is hard because that Carnotaur is so cool. Like when that thing starts to move forward, it's unreal. And then I don't know. We just looked at a rock. I don't know what's going on. The riverboat. I'm going with the riverboat. I gotta represent. Nick.
I agree with Rob. That may be my favorite attraction at Walt Disney World, but it's not my favorite scene by far in that attraction. So to pit these two show scenes up against each other, that Carnotaurus chasing down that vehicle is just amazing. So I'm voting for Dinosaur here.
Colleen, you're afraid of dinosaur.
I think that dinosaur's gonna eat me so every scary, time. Right? So I pick dinosaur because I don't want to ride the ride.
Yes. Lawrence tiebreaker.
I love this.
All right, Lauren.
I don't.
I mean, yeah, like the riverboat scene is like a big deal, but there's not enough like fights on it for me.
Wow.
Sorry, I had to. Yeah, I'm going to say the Carnotaurus. It makes my 29-year-old brother, this man has a child and a wife, and he gets so scared that he won't go on this ride because of the Carnotaurus.
He's just trying to protect them, Lauren. He's so good.
And for that reason, I have to go Carnotaurus.
Wow. Splash. All right. Okay, next. What's going on back there? Making your own jokes back there? Anyway,
maybe
what's next?
Maybe their jokes are funny.
All right, time for that rock now. Trapped Safari. From Jungle Cruise against the, Inner System Transport Ship. Is that the name of that?
That's the rotating, the middle.
Is that the Resistance Transport?
That's where you go out the same door, but it's
okay, different. Whatever.
Yes.
No, I know what scene it is. I don't know if it's inner system. All right, whatever. Lauren, why don't you start us off?
Well, the things went away. So.
Well, then pay attention. Put your phone away and pay attention.
I am trying to.
This is flashbacks of school for you?
No, they didn't catch me on my phone in school. I don't know. I feel like I have to go Rise of the Resistance. I feel like that scene is just very cool. I mean, Rise of the Resistance is just a cool ride in general. But yeah, Rise.
Colleen.
This is really hard because, like, I mentioned that scene earlier, and it's really great, but this is such an iconic scene from the Jungle Cruise.
The silence.
It's 11:45, no pressure.
Okay. I'm going to go Rise of the Resistance.
Nick.
Well, it's the difference between a scene that's like this is a work of art. Like, you look at it, and it's funny, and it tells the whole story. And then the Rise of Resistance, that's Jungle Cruise. And then the Rise of Resistance is an immersive experience that's like, wow, this is amazing. This is happening to me. Yeah. I'm in this.
And that's what I want. That's what I'm drawn to. I'm prisoner of the moment, maybe, but that's what I want. And so I would always pick the Rise of the Resistance scene over that static, like, all right, this is a cool, funny show scene. Great, it's iconic, it's great, it's perfection, but Rise of the Resistance is better.
This is, to me, this is the best part of Rise, bar none. Like the fact that you run outside, they rush you onto a ship.
Yeah.
You're in a spaceship, it's moving around and everything, and no one thinks they've left the place they were. And then that door, and they all, because they put the door on the other side. This would not be even close to as good if they didn't put that phony door on the other side that doesn't actually open. Boarding groups are gone, people have been on it now. And so the fact that there's a door that tricks you and then the other door reopens and people just go, what happened? That's, I think it's, storytelling wise in there, it's great, but also the reveal is fantastic. It's Rise, Allison.
As much as I love the new jungle, I like actually like the new Jungle Cruise, how they redid it is very, I really like that one. But I like how, not just the reveal, but I also like how if you're sitting in the front, then you get to see the animatronic.
Yeah.
But if you're in the back, there's also something in the back for you to watch that's different, and you can have a different experience whether you're in the front or in the back. And I think that was very, very thoughtful. So
that
I'm going with
the classic Disney depth, right? Where no matter where you're standing, there's a different show. There's a reason to stand in different places and come back and see it again.
Yeah. So, the Rise of the Resistance.
Desi.
As I mentioned, I'm voting Star Wars every time, so.
Desi, definitely.
Rob.
You're picking rides that are like 50 years apart from each other with technology as well. Yeah. But I think that this scene needs some love for the Jungle Cruise. We all know the puns in our head. Survival of the fastest. I'm gonna go Jungle Cruise.
Rob, that's the fun part of this like exercise, right? No, it really is. I'm just saying. Like,
no,
that's
true.
That's the fun part about this. Like, is a moment in time that is a masterpiece. Can that go up against an experience that, like, how we experience rides today?
Let's remember, everyone keeps saying the favorite to win is Flight into Imagination that was built in 1983. Right.
Right?
So we'll see what happens.
Yeah.
We'll see what happens. All right, that's the bracket. Send it back to the boys in the atrium.
Oh my goodness.
Again.
Wow.
Electrifying there. Now, that was. I've never seen a Mark Davis scene get almost shut out like that.
Is that unbelievable? Mark Davis, like, I mean, do people even know who he is anymore?
No.
First of all, apparently five dimensions is better than your own reflection. That's what I picked up right out of the gate.
I'm a little concerned about whether or not Nick uses this tattoo of the mirror to entice people. Want to see Bell's mirror?
Yeah, and I've seen that mirror in his back seat, and I too have been lured. In the big blue walls, what do you think? A big upset there.
That I was incredible. The moldy cave loses to the moldy tunnel.
Yeah, unbelievable.
They smell the same, but people just connect a little bit more with the
seat. This is a vlogger's nightmare. There is no cell service or Wi-Fi in the big blue world. I can't believe people even know what this ride is.
Also, we have all these people obsessed with duck butts. Butts in general.
Don't even get me started. I like duck butts, and I cannot lie, but...
Proof that a duck's butt is watertight, up close and personal. You can inspect it yourself for only $14.
I have webbed toes, and I cannot agree with some of these votes.
Muppet Vision. Let's talk about that one real quick.
Oh,
the
pre-show this has been
Muppet
something.
Vision. Yeah. A huge shutout over the herky-jerky lift hill of the Maelstrom that hasn't worked in like 10 years. But that doesn't stop them from still using it.
Yeah.
So that's no surprise.
A little bit.
And
also, some of the votes during the Rock and Roller Coaster, a bit of a super stretch when some of these arguments are being made.
That matchup was, I dare say, a shocker.
Yeah.
But the real close one there was the running Carnotaurus against the riverboat.
Well, if you know anything about a Carnotaurus, and believe me, I know something about
the
it.
The Carnotaurus.
We love to run. Look at this body. We are built for running.
The time said he slipped on a rock.
Yeah.
Are they that clumsy? Is that
fun fact, we will never catch you.
Is that when the dinosaurs are extinct now? Yeah. They can't run over a rock?
We can't catch you. Carnotaurus will never find you. We'll never catch you. And then let's finish up with a fake door over fake animals. What do you think?
The fake tour over fake, which matchup?
A fake door. We're talking about Star Wars.
Oh yeah.
Yeah.
A fake door. I mean, that is, we have both parts of the same scene still in the tournament. We have the hangar and the thing you walk out of to see the hangar.
I think that they were really smart putting 19 show scenes in this tournament to at least make sure they have a chance in the final four.
I, for one, can't wait. We have 8 more matchups to go tonight.
No, we don't.
There are 8 more. It's incredible. We're going to go back down under the rotunda.
Let's make sure everyone sets their alarms for 20 minutes from now to wake yourselves up. Let's get back into the tournament.
Back down under the rotunda.
I regret that decision.
It's so good.
Like, oh, let me have Pete. Pete and I will do it. No, I'll be fine. All right, what's next? What's the next? The three-headed troll from Twitter. I'm sorry, Maelstrom. Versus the Age of the Dinosaurs from the Universe of Energy. Rob.
This is one of the hardest ones for me of the entire thing. Because when you are waiting for those dinosaurs to appear, when that theater brings you in there, that is such a magical... Yeah. That's such a magical moment. But the three-headed troll is such a magical moment for Maelstrom. That was the thing. That one troll disappeared. Everybody remembers it. He sends you backwards. It's rough, but I'm picking Maelstrom.
Desi. Neither is Star Wars, so I don't know what to tell you.
I don't remember much of the dinosaurs, not because I was too young to remember it, but because I was always asleep. So
this
I got to
go with
Maelstrom.
5 minutes in, you were asleep.
All right. Good. Yep.
So would you pick Maelstrom?
Maelstrom.
Okay. Allison.
I'm picking Maelstrom as well. That's one of the most memorable things. It's when you start to go backwards, and then there's people that are like look over like behind them, and like, oh no, and then they start freaking out. It's like, just relax. But I like Maelstrom the best.
The reason people miss Universe of Energy is not really much of the rest of the attraction. It's really this scene. What you just saw there, like the silhouettes are all you see. As a kid, you see just those silhouettes of dinosaurs, and it's like, what is happening? And then as you pull up, the lights come up, and it's, I love the three-headed troll scene. I love it. But this dinosaur scene will stick with me forever. I got to pick the dinosaur scene. Nick?
What if they put 3 heads on one of the dinosaurs?
I mean, I already picked it, so yeah. It can only get better.
Yeah. The three-headed troll wins here.
Wow.
Out of pure, like, interesting show scene, like, no. This show scene, yeah.
Fiber optics, man.
The dinosaurs are great, but the troll was more memorable, more interesting. I'm going to pick that.
Colleen.
Universe of Energy bought those dinosaurs.
That was quick.
Lauren?
I knew.
Yeah, I mean, it doesn't matter, but I was also going to vote Universe of Energy.
Well, at least it was close.
I just remember those lights being
dinosaurs
so pretty.
Put up a fight. Mm. That's good. All right, next matchup. All right, up next we have the Departures Lobby from Star Tours in the queue against the future scene, the faraway future of 1994 from the Carousel of Progress. Nick, go ahead.
I'll be honest. I am shocked the future scene got into this tournament. Like, I don't understand the love for that scene. I don't know where it came from.
I think it's so corny that people love it.
Okay, I thought it was a laughing stock. There's no way I'm voting for that. I don't care what was up. You could have put the blue tunnel light thing, whatever that is,
the
from whatever
Kmart
attraction
sale.
That was, up against this, and I would have voted for the blue lights. No, I'm definitely not voting for the Carousel of Progress future scene. Star Tours.
Colleen?
100%.
Star Tours.
Lauren?
Star Tours.
Wow.
Easy.
Wow.
Rob.
Any other scene from Carousel of Progress.
What's the matter with you people?
I also, I also have a question.
No,
I have a
case.
Question.
There's two case. Hidden Mickeys in that scene. We made the oven is $5.50 as long as we keep our families together. Who cares? I do. I'm starving. Anyone for pizza? That scene is so much more. That scene is so much more. I didn't know I was invited to the Star Wars Best Scene Attractions bracket here. Let's go. Carousel of Progress.
Well, I have a question about this scene.
Is it supposed... What's a laser disc? Oh,
I also don't know what a laser disc is, but that doesn't need to be discussed right now.
I would say it's like a big DVD, but you probably don't know what those are either.
Let's ask your question. Okay.
Does it take place in 94, or is that when the last refurbishment was?
That was the last refurbishment. It kind of takes place in 1994, right? Like, everything they mention in that scene exists in 1994. There were new things. Laser disc and car phones and those things were kind of cutting edge. Actually, they kind of dated some of that even at that point.
Can we make this panel 20% brighter?
Wow. Wow.
Holy no, this is WDWNT.
Wow.
We're very...
Wow.
That's not how we work. Woo,
that was a sick burn. Like that oven.
Oh, wow.
Desi, go ahead.
I do love the oven scene. But
did he make the lights 20% brighter
yes!
than they actually did it? Oh, good. We're more washed out than
but
you.
But only one of these is
give
Star
Jake
Wars.
A raise.
No, Desi!
What did you pick?
Star Tours.
That's it!
That's
Star
great.
Wars oh! the park?
I can't even argue for Carousel of Progress! That's the reason why I'm here!
Best two out of three, Grandma?
For Carousel of Progress.
It's not the best scene in the darn attraction.
How many rings do you call for this?
When we took away the right for people at home to interfere in this, I was like, oh, good. Finally, the right things will win.
I can't believe
I was very wrong.
That was so stupid.
It was dated when it was made. How right. is that
that's
like
what's great about it.
I know.
The first or second scene. No, okay.
I make frozen pizzas every Christmas now.
You love
that is my tradition.
It can't be your favorite scene. It can't.
Definitely is.
That's weird.
Oh.
And it's definitely. Come on, how many calls?
Get out of here.
Or we're there, everybody's laughing, whether
Uncle
it's a.
Orville,
anyone can do that voice activation stuff.
They don't know what's going on.
I would have voted for any of the other three scenes.
So, yeah, Allison and I take Carousel Progress. It doesn't matter, but.
Thank goodness.
That's unfortunate.
Wow.
That's really unfortunate. We didn't even have a house phone.
Oh, my goodness.
All right. It's 4-3 for the Departures Lobby.
The Departures
the
Lobby.
Original
not
Star
even
Tours.
Star Tours.
Yeah. It's not even Star Tours.
I don't even get the joke.
It's better
like,
than that.
Yeah. Vehicle departure times. I could go to MCO and see the
no,
same
it
thing.
No, Carousel Progress, it's gone. It's gone, Allison. We got to move on. We got to move on.
You lost.
Next up. Wow.
Deal.
Wow. Flying over London in Peter Pan's flight against the Shaman of Song from Navi River Journey. Rob.
Oh, great. Start with me. it's very hard for me to not vote for Peter Pan based on all the nostalgia that comes with it. But the Shaman of Song is amazing. That's an amazing scene.
Yeah.
So although I tend to pick more classic things, I will pick that this time.
Desi.
Shaman of Songs. I mean, it's so impressive what they were able to do with that animatronic.
Allison.
This one I had trouble with. I'm actually going to go for Peter Pan. I think it's just so darn charming, so I'm going to pick Pan.
The Shaman animatronic is fantastic. The scene is not. Like, the rest of that scene is just the same foliage, like, repeating. Like, I love the song, and I love the animatronic. But I don't think it's a great scene. I think it's just a great, this was an animatronic tournament. Shaman's in like the final four, right? I'm going Peter Pan. Nick.
That's funny. I No.
The more Nick drinks, the meaner he gets.
Yeah, let's see what happens.
No, it's funny because I agree with Tom.
Yeah, that's what I'm
like,
here for.
I'm normally for like the new, the like new experience.
He said new, by the way.
I know.
I want to clarify, he said new.
Yeah, yeah. No, in this case, I agree with Tom. Like, if we're talking show scene and not animatronic, the Peter Pan scene blows that Navi scene out of the water. No pun intended. Kind of, maybe, I don't know. If it's funny, I'll intend it.
Whatever he said.
Yeah. No, really, Peter Pan. Peter Pan wins.
All right, Colleen.
Peter Pan is my favorite ride at Magic Kingdom, and I've mentioned Forced Perspective and other things, and
it
I love Peter Pan and flying over London. Peter Pan.
Lauren.
Peter Pan.
Peter Pan.
Wow.
We lost the scoreboard. I don't know. Peter Pan won. I don't.
Five to two.
I think. Yeah.
Shocked. 5-2. We lost the scoreboard. All right. What's up next? Oh, you just want me? I'll just read it if you've lost the graphics at this point.
Literally.
Veggie. At 12 o'clock, the free trial turns off. So.
Oh, God.
Veggie.
That wasn't
veggie,
a joke.
Veggie Fruit from Kitchen Cabaret versus Catastrophe Canyon. God, we have no visuals. Lauren, I have to explain both of these to you.
Oh, no.
Lauren, pick one. I don't know.
Why? Oh, why would you start with one? Me? And I don't know what
she
either
needs some
of
something. Context.
Either singing fruit or a natural
Wait,
disaster.
Wait, Catastrophe Canyon. That was a thing when I was alive.
That was
the backlot. Yeah.
That's right. Good job, Lauren.
I'll do that. Yeah.
Lauren will take
backlot
that one.
Tour, for sure.
I'll do Catastrophe Canyon as well.
Nick.
Catastrophe Canyon.
I'm going to take Catastrophe Canyon. Allison?
Catastrophe Canyon.
Desi?
Catastrophe Canyon.
And I know Rob.
As a former Backlot Tour employee, I am definitely taking Catastrophe Canyon.
Is this our
Sweet.
First 7?
Washed it away. Water came.
I agreed on something.
Washed the fruit away.
Nobody likes veggies.
So
that's what
true.
We agreed on.
Was even the best song?
Except for
song
California Adventure.
Based attraction
the
there.
Yeah.
I would rather die than eat a vegetable. It's not the first time I'll
Light
be quoted saying.
Drown me.
All right. The next one, the screen exploding from Mickey and Minnie's Runaway Railway, the one that's intended to at least.
Right.
And the 180 top, the top portion of Spaceship Earth where you look back at Earth, classic scene. Rob.
I am going to go with Spaceship Earth. I think that's a fantastic scene when you know you're at the very top of it. You get to see everything. It's it's very Epcot representative of that ride, too. I'm going with Spaceship Earth.
Of course, the 1994 version. Jeremy Irons, yeah.
Jeremy Irons, yes, of course.
It's a big wow moment. I got to go with Spaceship Earth.
Yeah. Allison?
Yeah, Spaceship Earth. It's like they time the words with the turning of the vehicle so perfectly. It's Spaceship Earth.
Nick.
Something from Runaway Railway got in this tournament.
Like, I had to have something for the kids.
Like, that's ridiculous. No, Spaceship Earth.
Yeah. Colleen.
I'm going to pick Runaway Railway just for shits and giggles.
Hey, it's past midnight.
Oh, I mean, hold on, Bernie.
You can't say that word.
It's past midnight.
Look.
I do have a question. Were you able to see anything besides Earth in that scene in previous years?
There was originally some stuff up there, yeah.
Oh.
But more towards when it's almost a new scene at that point.
Oh, okay.
So go with no.
Well, I mean, it doesn't matter.
People just yelling, just pick it. Just pick it.
I'll just do a railway just to be annoying.
Wow.
Why is everyone who's ever been my assistant the worst?
Wow.
I don't know, but you pick us.
That's true.
So.
God. Spaceship Earth, obviously, because Runaway Railway is a piece of garbage. All right. Next up, right? We have the town of Tumbleweed from Big Thunder Mountain Railroad and the Walt Disney World Railroad. Remember that, kids? And against the Wench Auction, the original auction scene from Pirates of the Caribbean. Don't groan. Original auction scene from Pirates of the Caribbean. Lauren, why don't you start us off since you're giggling?
You know, it's funny because Tom likes to make fun of me for being like woke Gen Z or whatever, but I'm actually going to go for the auction scene in this one.
You got your job back. Colleen.
Did I not have my job?
For about the last 15 seconds. There's a paper. You can take the paper off her desk. It's fine. All right, Colleen, go ahead.
I have absolutely no issue with Pirates of the Caribbean being changed, and I'm perfectly fine with the current auction scene. I'm still going to pick the old auction scene, but I just want it said.
That's fine. Nick.
Women power.
Love the auction scene, but Tumbleweed is where my heart lies. I think it's a better scene. Wow. I'm going with Tumbleweed.
All right. Ooh. Rob?
Tumbleweed's good. If you ever get a chance to look at it up close and personal, look at it because you fly by it so fast. But the other scene is just better. That auction scene is it's a wonderful scene when the gun goes off and the and it hits the sign on the other side. Auction scene.
Does he?
We wants the auction scene.
Allison.
Auction scene for me as well.
Nice.
I mean, the auction scene is one of the best staged, most incredible scenes. And I understand, obviously, with time, probably didn't age well. I get that. I get that changes were needed. I think we all agree the current scene is just, I don't think the current scene is good. I don't think it's well written. I think that's more the problem than the fact that they replaced an iconic scene. Is whatever you build has to be better than what it replaced. That's the rule of theme parks, right? And I don't think the scene they put in is better than what it replaced. But now the bar's real low for next time.
No one believes in that rule but you anymore.
So. It does seem like it. Well, when you're building the Radisson next to the Polynesian. Yeah, obviously the Wench auction.
1 to 6.
What was that?
1 to 6.
6 to 1. Yep. Okay, we got two left. The Caballero concert, the end with the audio animatronics from the Grand Fiesta Tour.
All three, like they're all actually there?
When they're all there, not the cutouts.
Okay, okay.
The cutouts will be in our worst attraction scene tournament. That's in hour 12. Stay tuned. More to come in tonight's marathon.
Definitely, we're casting.
And then the Savannah reveal from Kilimanjaro Safaris, Rob.
The Savannah reveal, absolutely. That's the best part of the safari ride. You see all these animals. You get to see the giraffes up close and personal. Yep. You turn that corner, it's just this big open land safari scene.
It's just breathtaking to see the safari when it, when you pull out in front of it and you see it, all the way across. I love it.
Allison.
Oh, definitely the Savannah scene. There's no question.
I'm going for the Caballeros.
What?
What do you mean, what? They're amazing animatronics that Tokyo
really
took very
animals.
Good care of from the Mickey Mouse review. They're three of my... I never in my life thought I was going to get to see those characters as animatronics. We only ever get stuff that's like contemporary films, right? It's never... They never really go back. And especially, I like a lot of weird... stuff from Disney's past, and the fact that there's a ride about the three Caballeros, I can't believe that ever got made, and the fact that it got plussed with animatronics is, it's a wonderful thing. So, Caballeros. Nick?
Yeah, these are three of my current favorite animatronics on Walt Disney World property, but I can't not vote for that Savannah scene. That is a... breathtaking moment on a real journey. I mean, that's what Animal Kingdom's all about. And I think that show scene is better than three animatronics on stage because it's real life. And you never know what you're going to see out there on the Savannah when you look out there. You may see some LED lights in the distance and you may see some gazelles.
The Jumbotron.
Yeah.
Colleen.
The Safari is one of my top four favorite rides, but I actually kind of think I want to say the Three Caballeros. That was what hit me first, because I guess I never would have thought about the Savannah Brazil as a show scene. But I really like the Three Caballeros, and yeah, it was really cool that animatronics showed up one day.
Yep. Lauren?
I'm going to go with Grand Fiesta Tour. Those are my favorite fake fireworks.
They're wonderful.
That's not even a joke. Like, there's so many fake fireworks in Disney Parks, like finale scenes. I can't afford that one, but no, these are my favorite fake fireworks. I mean, I love all fireworks, but these are my favorite fake ones.
Can't beat fiber optics, man. You keep trying, you can't beat them.
Yeah.
All right, so yeah, the Savannah does win, but it was close.
We tried.
All right, this is the last one. This should take 8 seconds. This is the reveal of the presidents in the Hall of Presidents versus the Wizard of Oz from the Great Movie Ride. Lauren.
Oh, this is the best scene in that ride. I said earlier that the gangsters wasn't. That's because this one is. So, Wizard of Oz all the way.
Colleen.
Wizard of Oz.
Nick.
Presidents.
Yeah, I know. This was like the one we gave Nick because we felt bad. It's fine. It's all right, Nick. You can vote for it. Allison?
Wizard of Oz.
Desi?
Wizard of Oz.
Rob?
Yeah, man, Munchkinland, Wizard of Oz.
What a shame that we lost this. This scene is magnificent. This is the greatest movie perhaps ever made, and it was represented beautifully in an attraction, and it's a shame that it no longer exists. But yeah, we'll talk about it more as weeks progress. Wizard of Oz, clean sweep. All right, that's it for us down there. Take it away, Eric and Pete. Are still awake?
Pete, again, just incredible action down there by the panel.
Unbelievable. What a round.
We started off with a very close matchup. We had the three-headed troll against the Age of Dinosaurs from Universe of Energy.
Yeah, honestly, trolls winning again. Tom cannot stop the trolls.
Yeah, we like dinosaurs. Like, Tom went crazy for the dinosaurs on a Disneyland Railroad last week. Universe of Energy, where Ellen was canceled before it was cool. I have to say, that was an incredible matchup. But the three-headed troll marched on to the next round. Next, we had the Departures Lobby against the Future Scene from Carousel
Tough to beat. When you're at 888 degrees, it's going to be hard to beat when you're bringing the heat.
Look, we already sent the dead grandma on to the next round in the ballroom scene, so she could stay in 1994 in the Carousel of Progress.
Love that. She's still in the game, and I agree 100%.
I did make a note that Nick remarked that his criticism of that was that it's not the best scene on that ride, implying that the tip board on the Departures Lobby was the best scene
Nick
in Star
made
Tours.
Some really great comments tonight and some questionable ones, but I think we can all agree is that Nick is right half of the time.
Okay.
Also have a comment here, veggie, nope, no one cares.
What about the flying over London over the Shaman of Songs? So the most advanced, one of the most advanced animatronics around, losing out to a bicycle chain with some glow-in-the-dark paint on it. I think that was pretty incredible.
I think my dad would be very proud because this looks like my garage most of the time.
Yeah, that's true. Then you go to veggie, fruit, getting smoked by Catastrophe Canyon. Smoked vegetables, delicious. You should try them sometime.
Drowned, fired, everything great. You know what else was great? The auction scene winning. I think I really deserved to win, especially during Women's History Month.
I think it's important to see that by a score of 6-1, our panel was celebrating human trafficking. And we'll see how that does in the next round.
Yeah. Also great to see that three ducks firing guns almost beat out some really cool animatronics on the safari.
That is also true. And don't forget, you missed the screen exploding, losing to the top of Spaceship Earth.
Almost forgot about that. I'm glad you brought that up.
Someone kicking a dog lost out to early 80s Epcot.
Unbelievable. We know some dogs just need a good kick in the rear end into a trunk, if you know what I'm saying.
And no surprise to anyone, the Wizard of Oz, that beautiful animatronic, beat all the 40-something animatronics in the Hall of Presidents.
Yeah, it's hard to find a good president, but you know what? We love fiction.
For all we know, she is in the Hall of Presidents now.
Somewhere, and you know what? I will not give up hope.
Keep a sharp eye out, Pete. The next round is just around the corner next Thursday.
I can't wait.
We will have we're down to 32 teams. That's 16 matchups.
What are we going
to
talk about?
Hopefully even a shorter show. So with that, we're going to send it back to Tom down under the rotunda to sign us off.
They're still
here? Still here. Unlike the Wizard of Oz scene, we're still here. Oh, all right. Anyway, we'll be back next week. Please join us. It will be shorter, I promise. And remember, kids, what a life. Good night.